The United Nations Peace Day was celebrated in Austin, Texas. That's right. United Nations Peace Day, a celebration of complete hypocrisy.
It is so critically important that we join with the United Nations effort begun in 1981 to declare this day the day of peace and to recognize and celebrate the 11 days of global unity beginning on September 11th. And whereas the International Day of Peace challenges all people of the world, to consider what it means to be human and to rededicate themselves to our shared humanity. Now, therefore, I, Steve Adler, mayor of the city of Austin, Texas, do hereby proclaim September 21st of the year 2016 as Peace Day in Austin, Texas.
The same United Nations fomenting the growing possibility of World War III as Russia is demonized rather than met with diplomacy simply because they will not bend to the will of globalism.
Bilateral relations have taken a turn for the worse for the U.S. and Russia. Moscow has suspended an agreement on the disposal of surplus weapons-grade plutonium. The Kremlin said unfriendly acts by the U.S. towards the Russian Federation pushed President Vladimir Putin to sign a decree halting the agreement, which came into force in 2010.
In the face of none of these atrocities, has Russia expressed outrage, nor has it demanded investigations, nor has it ever called for a Saturday night emergency consultation in the Security Council? And a year ago, at the UN General Assembly, Russia decided to join the Assad regime, escalating the conflict, and perhaps worst of all, itself adopting some of the regime's worst practices.
That's all to confuse the public that we, our government, gave a bunch of weapons in Syria, in Libya, a bunch of other places to Al-Qaeda to make those countries be failed states. Our governments collectively put them there. That's the big enchilada. That's the 20 trillion pound elephant in the room. That's the dead dog, you know, under the floorboards that's stinking the house up. This is the issue. And if the governments of the world can get away with this, they can pretty much say 2 + 2 = 100.
You know, the same United Nations with peacekeeper forces that routinely rape the children they are there to protect.
It's doing everything we possibly can to assist the victims, to bring accountability and justice for them.
The same United Nations that is on the verge of crossing the threshold on the ratification of the Paris Climate Pact, which under UN Agenda 2030 will tax every human activity and force humanity into densely packed megacities under UN control. The same United Nations gradually taking control of your local police force under the Strong Cities Network to establish a global New World Order police state. The same United Nations that wants to replace the natural world with a genetically modified one. Yeah, that United Nations. Oddly enough, the host of this hypothetical UN Peace Day was clueless of the United Nations Agenda 2030.
I'm afraid I'm not familiar with 2030.
If you weren't aware of it already, Agenda 2030 is a ramp-up of the totalitarian Agenda 21, intended to accelerate the New World Order system, with major changes beginning in 2018. Meanwhile, populism is sweeping the planet, and the anxiety festering amongst the globalists is rising. A Bloomberg chart documents the usage in terms like uncertainty, fear, risk, worry, destabilize, and tensions, among others. From the meeting of the UN Agenda 2015 Assembly until the latest UN Agenda 2016 Assembly. And it's as blatantly obvious as the UN Agenda's supposed Peace Day, which appears inviting on the surface. But anyone taking the time to read Agenda 2030 will quickly come to the conclusion that the United Nations is nothing less than an arm of the globalists creating a new world order hell on earth. John Bound for Infowars.com.
Absolutely. That is what it was set up to do. We'll be back. Stay with us. I'm Alex Jones, your host. Thank you for joining us. We just kicked off another transmission. My friends, we are historically, culturally, spiritually, economically, militarily, 2 seconds from midnight on the doomsday clock. And war's never going to happen until it happens. You're never going to get cancer till it happens. You're never going to have a heart attack till that aorta blows or your heart seizes up. You're never going to be in a car wreck till you drive through the green light and somebody runs it and T-bones you. Your wife, your husband, your kids are bleeding to death in front of you. I don't bring up the negative aspects of this world, the painful aspects of this world, because I celebrate them. I bring them up because I want to mitigate and banish them as much as we can. I want to bring light into the world, not deception. I want prosperity. I want justice. I want innovation. And I thought everybody else wanted that. You know, most of the common people around this world, no matter what color their skin are, want basic justice and a better future for their children than they had. That's what unifies us. We're one species. We're one race. But different breeds, different variants. But we've all survived as a species on this planet, and we are the sum travails and adventures and tumultuous, freebooting, legendary past that is reality. We are the sum of our ancestors and all of their struggles. And everything the social engineers do is to cut us off from our ancestors and from that past and those histories. Because if we can be cut off from that, we are cut off from ourselves and from our collective intellect and who we are. And if you don't know who you are, you don't have a hope in this world. And instead, they're giving us false myths of who we are. Innovation now is reducing the language and finding offense in all things and being catatonic basket case lunatics. That's a rear guard action of the globalists that have stolen the future, stolen civilization, and are now giving us a distorted version of an artificial construct. Humans separate themselves from the animals in many ways, but one of the chief is we build our own environment. We use tools and change the universe around us. We innovate. Whales didn't launch jet aircraft into the air or plumb the secrets of the atom. Whales didn't paint Vincent van Gogh's sunflowers. Whales did not create the symphony that is Beethoven's genius, as magic as whales are. The divine spark given by God to his creation, made in the image of the creator of reality, of the universe, of consciousness. Imagine the hills that creator climbed. Imagine the roots of that creator. Now wishing to re-experience its own genesis. Recreating it here. On this solar system, on this planet. In this galaxy. And you say out of billions and billions and billions and hundreds of billions of galaxies that they've now photographed and chronicled and named in many cases, they've given them all numbers. As we stare out into infinity, as we stare out in many cases at galaxies that don't even exist anymore, and then you ask yourself, do we come from the divine when the evidence is written in the firmament of the night sky? Think about that. And then you see how far we've fallen. There's a lot of news to cover today. And I don't celebrate people's ignorance. I point it out so that we can not go down the same road again and again. You know, they say that a fool learns from experience. Well, they don't really ever learn, do they? But the average person learns from, you know, walking through a field at night without a flashlight, step in a hole, break your ankle, blow your Achilles, whatever. I've been a fool. It's happened to me more than once. Confidence killed the cat. But a wise man learns from other people's mistakes. And yesterday, towards the end of the broadcast, before I handed the baton to Paul Watson, I just mentioned to Congressman Hank Johnson, who thought that Guam, one of the main military base islands the U.S. has in the Pacific, was floating. He's a current congressman, by the way, and would tip over. He said it 4 years ago, and he was very serious. He thought islands float. You know, he thinks rocks and mountains and things like that, they float. And I mentioned that because I thought it was parallel to what other members of Congress were asking the Joint Chiefs of Staff chairman a few weeks ago about, can't you just shoot down the Russian airplanes with cruise missiles? That way none of our pilots get hurt. And they go, excuse me, but then they're going to retaliate against us. And they get, but we won't have any pilots in the air. It'll be cruise missiles. There's like an hour-long hearing, and the general keeps looking at him and like, you know, like a cat looking at a fish in a fishbowl. It's like, really? I mean, what are you doing? What are you? Are you a man? Are you a mouse? Are you a goldfish? And then I saw people on YouTube last night. I happened to go to the video of this that was uploaded from the show, and people didn't believe that there was a congressman that said that islands floated. And they also, I noticed, because I read hundreds of the comments, I got fascinated, they were having a discussion. They didn't know why it was wrong to shoot down Russian airplanes with cruise missiles. And they didn't understand there'd be a response back. So they got that Hank Johnson is obviously mentally retarded. I mean, look at him. I mean, he's the thing. That's the globalist. That's who they got rid of Cynthia McKinney and installed, is a mentally retarded man, in my view. I mean, I'm very sad for him, but he's obviously mentally retarded. We'll skip this break. This is too important. Yeah, you look at him, I say that's someone who's retarded. You look at Tim Kaine, I say he looks like somebody that's a pedophile. Not saying he's a pedophile, just looks like a pedophile. By the way, when I said that yesterday and said it every hour on the hour, I in my gut, I said the media is not going to pick up on this. You know why? Because they put that headline out there and people go, yeah, he does look like one. See, when we say something that's really true, the enemy doesn't attack it. And everything, you know, we say gets attacked one way or the other, except stuff so veritas that they can't handle it. So before I get to all this news, and believe me, it's incredible today. It's over the top. Let me try to quantify what we're dealing with here. I can play a clip of a congressman talking in the Defense Committee about islands floating. They're not the tips of mountains above the ocean. They're floating. This is what the establishment actually put in office. I mean, in this case, the whole media got behind this guy, and the Democrats and Republicans got behind him to get rid of Cynthia McKinney because she's a smart lady. And under political correctness, because she's black, they'll go, oh, you're patronizing. No, she has a lot of courage. She's a smart lady. You know, like when I say Rand Paul's smart. See, we're not even allowed to have discussions because they put landmines in there to the public so mentally ill, they just hear me complimenting a black woman, and I'm not allowed to. Point is, they get rid of this woman that has incredible courage, demonized everywhere. A lot of conservatives are probably listening going, Cynthia McKinney, she's horrible. No, you got brainwashed about her because she was so real. She exposed government kidnapping rings of kids and got Rumsfeld to admit it was going on. She exposed vaccines being deadly and hurting the troops. She exposed all these phony wars. She exposed Barack Obama as even worse than Bush. That's why they ran her out. And they put a guy in that thinks islands are floating rocks. That's even dumber than flat earthers, okay? And then I get up here with the geopolitical, military, basic research. And you know, I'll talk to retired generals or other people or people in former CIA or current, you know, and they sit there and they go, we just can't believe you know all these factoids and stuff, you know, even the brain bugs that our organizations don't. And I'm not bragging. I actually study things. I actually want to know how things work. Most people just want to act like they're informed and have a few things they say to look like they know what's going on. I want to know how the universe works. It's so incredible. But to get back why I'm covering this so much today up front, because it deals with the mindset of the public and what the globalists are targeting, but what they themselves have become, U.S. Army chief threatens war with Russia. Okay, we played that clip yesterday. We're going to play it again. He says, this is going to be as big a war as World War II, and we're being maneuvered into the position, so I just want Russia to know we're ready for war with you, since Russia's having nuclear drills and says they're prepared for war. And the Pentagon demands no-fly zone over Russia, and the chairman of the Joint Chiefs said, okay, yes, we can shoot down, because they're telling him in the longer clip, well, listen, so our pilots don't get hurt, can't we just shoot them down with cruise missiles? And the general goes, yeah, but then we'll have to go to war with Russia. They're going to retaliate. And then and Republicans and Democrats for like an hour go, but because they all want a war. That's what real patriots do. You know, you go start a war, especially when you're in the wrong. And they go, but we've got thousands of shipborne launched and aircraft launched cruise missiles in the area. We'll shoot down all the Russian planes. And the chairman keeps looking at him going, yeah, we'll have to go to war with Russia. So I don't have the authorization for that. So you're telling me, and basically Obama has given the order 4 years ago, and they're still giving it, to shoot down any aircraft in the air, including Russia. And the military keeps not following the order because they want the order, attack Russia. Attack Russian aircraft. And you know what? I think if they get that order, they'll probably do it. From the commander-in-chief, even though he's not the commander-in-chief and they shouldn't. But that's the point we've gotten to with they're not even operating one-dimensional. One-dimensional. They're not even at the level of checkers, folks. They're not at the level of kindergarten connect the dot. And when I say that, I don't mean that to insult them. I mean literally. They think islands are floating. They think you shoot down a couple hundred Russian aircraft. The first one you shoot down, Russia's going to run to the UN. And there's going to be all sorts of sanctions and flipping out. The second one you shoot down, Russia's going to tell you, we're going to fire our hypersonic missiles that go 4,000 miles an hour at your ship's launching aircraft the next time you enter the airspace, the next time a missile enters. Then more missiles enter. Russians attack with conventional ship killers, knocking out a U.S. aircraft carrier in the Mediterranean. Then, more attacks on Russian bases. Next, the Russians roll into Europe. NATO has said they will launch short-range and intermediate-range nuclear weapons onto those armored columns coming into Eastern and Western Europe. Boom! ICBMs get launched by Russia or by the U.S. Everybody's dead. Okay? Listen to you goddamn dumbasses in Congress. Islands don't float. And you cannot shoot down the Russian aircraft in a sovereign country they were invited into on their doorstep while they're fighting Al-Qaeda, murdering Christians by the hundreds of thousands. You can't do it. Just because George Soros thinks he's Jesus Christ doesn't make him Jesus Christ. And by the way, I purposely did not use the Lord's name in vain. You people are damned to hell. I love how the Baptists and everybody else who I was brought up by, you know, they won't get upset about the abortuaries. And I'm not singling out Baptists and everything else. And they all, you know, what do you call bottle openers for beer? You call them church keys for Baptists. Oh, they'll all, you know, henpecky about drinking beer or whatever while they're the biggest drunks around. Oh, but if you say GD, that's taking the Lord's name in vain because some preacher said. No, that means God is going to damn these people to hell. A curse is when you call for God to be destroyed and say the devil is better than God. People don't even know what they're talking about. I'm so sick of all these ignorant morons. We are run by a country of people that think islands float, and that you and preachers that think if you say someone should go to hell. I know I shouldn't judge, and I'm not saying somebody should go to hell, but people that want to destroy our planet and want to murder Christians all over the world, I think are going to hell. And I'll say I hope God sends them to hell. But anyways, I saw people in there not believing that Hank Johnson worries Guam could capsize. That's CBS News, Fox News, congressman who once feared Guam could capsize, compares Jewish settlers to termites. In Quake's wake, Representative Hank Johnson revives claim that Guam could tip over. And that's why we have this hurricane coming in. Matthew, that they say millions of people should evacuate. It killed a bunch of people in Haiti. God rest their souls. We have another member of the media. Ron Allen thinks climate deal is designed to stop storms like Hurricane Matthew. There have always been hurricanes. There's always been cyclones. There's always been tornadoes. There's always been tsunamis. There's always been earthquakes. There's always been volcanoes, okay? Yeah, I used to think maybe that guy was just saying that to get idiots, you know, young kids or whatever, to believe, you know, pay carbon tax, there'll be no more tornadoes or earthquakes or anything else. But, man, there's a dust storm, global warming. There's an earthquake, global warming. There's a tsunami, global warming. There's a hurricane, global warming. There's a typhoon, global warming. And mainstream media is saying that Hurricane Matthew is because of global warming, when in the last 50 years, we have been in one of the least busy hurricane systems that we've ever seen in the last 5 years. I mean, it is. You just Google that from the Weather Channel. It's a fact. But still, they're there. I mean, you always read about whole armadas, you know, blown off course and everybody killed, thousands of sailors because they went into a storm. You know, sailors, storms, ships, they were there before. But this is the magnitude of idiocy. Let's play the congressman, again, to illustrate what we're dealing with here, not knowing of that islands are mountains. Here it is.
Yeah, my fear is that the whole island will become so overly populated that it will tip over and capsize.
We don't anticipate that. The Guam population, I think, currently about 175,000. And again, with 8,000 Marines and their families, it's an addition of about 25,000 more into the population.
The whole island will become so overly populated that it will tip over.
That's enough. Now, again, it's only one step from that. You know, 60 IQ, 65, maybe 60. I mean, we're talking dumb, okay? He wasn't joking. He still believes it, reportedly. To the other congressman, in the hours of footage I've watched, saying, can't you just blow up the Russians? Can't you just... Well, no, our treaties say we can, and our military gave the Russians the intel to help take out the targets, and they'll attack us back, and then that starts a nuclear war. But we have pilotless weapons. No one will be hurt. Yeah, until they get out of the theater. Okay, I just spent the last 25, 30 minutes just getting into the abject, dumbed-down level of the public and the arrogance and the delusional behavior that goes on. I'm not going to get back into U.S. Army chief threatens war with Russia. We played the clip yesterday. Pentagon demands no-fly zone for Russia over Syria after the White House orders them to basically push that idea, which will then mean war with Russia. Russia is engaged in World War III drills with 40 million people taking part in that. And according to the chairman of the Joint Chiefs, no-fly zone would require a war with Syria and Russia. That is a close quote. Okay, now there's all this other news, but I keep going back to this because it's central, but not just to cover the story mindlessly, to be educated on what we're dealing with. We have members of Congress that think islands float. We can laugh at them all day long, but that's who's been elected to Congress. Then you've got Republicans and Democrats that just keep going for the last few years. Well, why can't we just shoot down the Russian aircraft, General? And they go, because Russia has nuclear weapons and has promised to retaliate. and has retaliated before when the West gets on its borders. I mean, Dick Cheney and George Bush had to back off when they started a war in 2008, remember? A proxy war taking over South Ossetia and Abkhazia. So all this is going on, and then I get this response, oh, you're a Russian agent. I'm not even going to respond to that at this point, okay? If people don't understand, we shouldn't be backing jihadis. We shouldn't be trying to have failed states in Libya and Syria and Egypt. We shouldn't be overthrowing our allies and installing. I was reading today where London has hired a jihadi to teach cultural enrichment who calls for the murder of homosexuals and everything else. It's like Uma Abedin. Who could make it up that her mother's the main author and proponent calling for women to be sexually mutilated? I mean, what? This is the woman Hillary stays in the same hotel room with, her girlfriend's mother is the top pushing mutilating women's genitals. And then I have to sit there and see all these weird feminist groups clucking and hopping around and, you know, talking all day about how great it is to be for women. And that brings me to our next big piece, because it's bigger than just Hillary hiring actors. I saw this town hall. And that's why I'm so frustrated, because I'd rather cover one or two stories properly than cover 1,000 improperly. But I remember just seeing a clip of this town hall yesterday and going, that's completely fake. That's produced. And then it gives, and if I just go with my gut, then I can move on and just keep making all the right decisions. Because if I pull back and go, why do I know that? Then the headache happens, because then, okay, number one, that crowd looks completely fake. How do you know that? Approximation. I can see how they're spaced out, laid out in quadrants, not even properly done. I can then look at how everyone has certain dress, certain unity of the crowd, the demographics of the crowd, the lighting. I can see that it's shot in the highest level HD, perfectly lit. Again, my subconscious brain, hundreds of times more powerful than my conscious, can see the fact that clearly there's lighting change differences and different sequences that have been shot. And the whole thing clearly has been highly produced. Let's just boil it down. Boom. Highly produced, totally fake, done to make her look like a rock star with all these, you know, beautiful movie stars with her. The lighting all done perfectly, but then added blurs put on the lenses to make it then look fake on top of that. Sophisticated hammered crap. So I see this, boom, get a headache, because I won't just go with my gut. That's fake. No, never go with your gut, even though it's always right. Let's analyze it. And I'm watching it, and then I get angry. I move on. I forget about it. Boom, get up this morning. Confirmed. Hired actors. And by the way, you can go through most of the crowd. Again, all we can do with HUMAT is analyze the one girl. But you can go through the entire crowd. We just have her name so we know, because they were so arrogant. This is one of their blind spots. They're still operating like we wouldn't look up the fact that she is a highly successful young actress who's been in movies, TV shows, you name it, and that the whole thing was scripted and completely fake. Just like we knew that it was the former Bush administration official, you know, mid-level, they don't, you know, saying to Trump, why is it you hate women so much? We're tired of you, and the perfect swagger and how she said it. Everybody said, boom, look into that lady. That looked really, really polished. Boom, fake again. This is even more fake. The whole thing's fake. A huge production where they just wheel Hillary in to sit there like the queen, with everyone looking at her like the great goddess of knowledge that will deliver us into Valhalla. You're no goddess, my sweetie. Unless you're Kali, perhaps. Fake Hillary. Clinton takes questions from child actor. Corporate media regurgitates footage. In fact, this should be red linked. This should be tweeted out. Disaster for Hillary. It's all how we phrase it, and it should be. Disaster. Hillary caught using child actors to attack Trump. That's the real headline. I want to say something else just so you understand where I'm coming from. Not to brag, but so everybody gets in the real game-winning mindset here. I was given Some of these have never before been seen. These were captured by, let's just say, multinational intelligence agency. I'll just tell you, NATO. Showing Al-Qaeda / ISIS making captured troops they're about to execute eat human flesh as a person's chopped up on a table so that they believe that will send their souls to hell. Oh, you're supposedly good Muslims like us, but we want to send you straight to hell before we kill you in a mass grave and chopping people's heads off. And a bunch of this we haven't even shown you. In fact, we've got even more than what WorldNet Daily's got. But I knew Dr. Corsi has such gravitas in 3 number one New York Times bestsellers and all the sources of the Middle East, and he's the one that exposed a lot of this. So he deserves this intel. He'll do a better job with it. He has more gravitas on that area than I do. I don't even have the staff or crew to be able to do the proper job because they're not international experts in the Middle East who live there for off and on, you know, a decade. So I told the sources, I said, just go ahead and give that to Dr. Jerome Corsi. He's now going to do a 5-part series. The second is out today. See Hillary's Libyan jihad atrocities. Let me explain something. No one else in media acts like that and behaves like that except Matt Drudge. If we've got the truth and a weapon that is more powerful fired through the ocular vision of Dr. Corsi, I'm telling you, I keep telling plenty. If someone shows up better than me at any aspect, I'm going to put them front and center because I want to win. This isn't about being a big shot, ladies and gentlemen. I'm going to get back to this in a minute. It's about understanding the globalists are out to get us. They're not out to conquer us to build a better civilization because we're a bunch of, you know, miscreants or whatever. They're not here with Kipling's, you know, white man's burden, which was bad enough and became exploitive, but they actually meant well. This is a hate letter to humanity. This is horrible, evil, wicked people that, notice Hillary surrounds herself with ugliness. And then this is a sign of the psychopathic behavior. This is what they're into. Okay, that's why she always uses cute little sweet little girls, the image of innocence, because it's what she isn't. It's what she's the furthest from. She's a 180. And they've really exploited this little girl. There's a gentleman, a reporter, does a lot of great work who broke it down with the Spangled newscast. And I'm going to play it here. But CNN, quote, carried the full 5 minutes. That means the full, find my article with all the video links. That's the full fake production. Oh, did you hear she had a town hall? Yeah. It was 5.5 minutes long, and they played a few other clips throughout the day. This is, let's go back to the town hall. It was produced a day earlier. And that's what's crazy is I've sent reporters and I've analyzed the raw footage. We've shown it to you at different events she's at around the country. And when she's having convulsions and stuff, everybody's kind of like in on it and knows. And they're like very proud to be covering it up. And then, oh, Hillary's going to be behind closed for 45 minutes or an hour. And then she comes out looking like she just got run over by a train. I mean, I'll hand it to her. She gives speeches after having full grand mal seizures. I mean, they're sticking, you know, plastic spoons in her mouth. I mean, you know, she's going through some hell right now with that growing brain tumor, where it is. So here's CNN in on whole fake productions. Oh, but there wouldn't be a rigging of his microphone, Donald Trump's, which they now admit they did. No audio to the crowd. Some people 30, 40 rows back couldn't hear anything. No audio from Donald Trump. And he's really uncomfortable. Imagine, he doesn't want to say, hey, my mic's not working. But imagine, you go up to give a speech. She's there. She's booming out the crowd. You're not being heard. Okay, well, you're Donald Trump. You can readjust. All of a sudden, you're being interrupted. Okay, well, I was against the Iraq war. No, you weren't, Lester Holt says. Hillary, no, you weren't. Debate Commission comes out and says, yeah, actually, there was no audio to the crowd, and his audio, for some reason, was being faded down, up and down to the TV viewers. I mean, I could hear it. I was like, half the time, and then you had to just fade it down where he sounded like he was this little whispering weakling. So there wasn't anything personal about his voice to you. And they rigged the polls, and they rigged the Google, and they rigged. I mean, it's ridiculous. Any person with half a brain would say, obviously, if I don't like the establishment, this is who we should go with. Oh, but no. The average public, they don't actually want to overthrow the aristocracy and create a new future for humanity based on the Renaissance, the New Atlantis. They just want to be the aristocrat. That's why when the elites have tried to buy me off, they go, well, look, you can go ahead and join us. We'll make you real rich. And I'm like, you don't understand. I don't want to be you. I want the best humanity can be. That's what I believe in. I'm a fan of humanity. I'm a fan of man. And then people go, oh, that's from the devil's advocate. You're the devil. No, that's another Hollywood lie. The devil is the opposite of a fan of man. The devil hates man because we're made in the image of his creator. We're his boss. He knows it. That's why the globalists act like this. They hate productivity and prosperity and unity and strength and honor and will and courage and duty. They have the best we've got go out and do incredible things militarily, horrible things in many cases, but then they hate them the most because they absolutely fear this great male example of a focused soldier. And they dress up all their crimes to sell it. They dress up all their crimes in the foliage of liberty, in the foliage of strong, virile men. And God's energy and force to build and to procreate, to pollinate. They're at war with life. People say, why do they attack the family? Because they're at war with life, because their father is a worshiper of death. Not death. Death is an aspect of God's creation. Death is the tilling of the soil. But the devil fashions himself to be death because perhaps stranger eons, even God could die. Death is the only godly aspect the devil can actually manifest, because the devil doesn't want to give any creation to man, even though the devil can't create and can only steal what man creates. And then can only twist it. So we know the little name of the girl that's in movies and TV shows and everywhere. And then she goes up with a script with all these other scripted people and looks at Hillary like she's the Messiah. The article's on Infowars.com. It should be the top story in the country. But it should be Hillary devastated by news that she has child actors. And let me tell you, I can look at these other kids and I can look at the fake sincerity and mommy having them, you know, in the acting classes since they were two, because that's mommy's ticket to getting some money and getting out of the trailer and all the rest of it. I mean, I can take one approximation. Boom. Actors, actresses. Boom. Boom. Hell, they got her being interviewed by an actress on the stage with Webster Hubble's daughter. They're using actors. Of course they are. Hillary Clinton has been caught in yet another staged fake town hall style question-answer exchange, this time with a child actor who was planted. And notice they even used a small crowd because they know she doesn't have big crowds. Everybody's already aware of that, but also because it's hard to get more actors. And a lot of them then, if you get too big a crowd, some of them might be patriots recording it, showing it's fake. And it turns out her father is a Democratic operative. And they were so proud of their little daughter. They thought no one would notice. They thought no one would be aware of it. They thought no one would understand it. Turns out he's for gun ban. Turns out he's for open borders. They're all a bunch of actors. We're going to come back and play her from CNN. You know, they say that I say nobody died at Sandy Hook. What I've said, and the debates we've held looking at both sides, is Anderson Cooper did blue screen. He turns his nose, disappears. The kids are going in circles in and out of the building like it's a drill. Nothing matches up. That's all I said. And these people have been caught staging so much stuff, who knows? Aurora, that was staged. And that takes an hour to get into, but that was staged. Let me just give you one little niblet of information on that front. The supposed shooter was in a super secret, above top secret DARPA brain interface program with the CIA, MIT, and NASA, and his father wrote one of the top algorithms. I could go on for about an hour, but Aurora was staged. Just like Sirhan Sirhan and RFK. Now, when we come back, I'm going to play you this clip of the child actress right out of Wag the Dog worshiping at the altar of Hillary Rodham Clinton. This should devastate the witch if we get the information out. Now, another another shirt that was designed and licensed from Roger Stone is the Bill Clinton rape shirt. Looks like the, you know, communist-style Obama hope shirt that says rape. Wear it. Get aggressive. Start the conversations. Get on TV with it. In fact, I'm going to say this right now. Anyone that gets on national TV with the shirt clearly for more than 5 seconds gets $1,000. That means, you know, behind cameras, you name it. Anyone that gets it on air on national TV and gets the words out, Bill Clinton is a rapist, or things along that line with a bullhorn, I could go to this right now. $5,000 until a budget of $100,000 has been spent.
Adoptable dogs. Well, every year, the Best Friends Animal Society helps cats and dogs who are stuck in animal shelters find homes.
Bill Clinton is a rapist.
We've got.
But I think one of the kind of the things that we really need to be looking at in this debate is that Bill Clinton is a rapist. Infowars.com. Infowars.com. Bill Clinton's a rapist. Bill Clinton is a rapist.
All right.
Bill Clinton.
And I got this Hillary for Prison t-shirt, and I just want everyone to know about this, like, big presidential campaign that Bill Clinton is a rapist. Infowars.com.
Okay. Thank you very much, Terrence.
After we make sure everybody gets a chance to participate, after we help families succeed in the most important job of any society, raising children, and succeed at work, how can we live together with all of our diversity so we can all arrive together? How can we be safe in the world?
We've had a $100,000 contest before. My budget's $100,000. That means if, you know, a bunch of people do this, I'll pay up to $100,000 and stop it. That's $1,000 if you just get the shirt on national TV. Visually, rape. Okay? It is $5,000 if you get the audio. Legally and lawfully. They got to be outdoors, one of their little events. You got to have a bullhorn. You got to have the shirt on or have somebody with it. Or maybe a big sign with it on it, and two of you hold it up, and then somebody else bullhorns, Bill Clinton is a rapist, not a philanderer. Hillary covers up the rape. Look, I'm not going to sit here and say, see, I told you so, that communist Chinese-style net censorship is coming to the web, because it's already here. It's being announced. The way you keep the internet open and free is you get involved more than ever. Go to Infowars.com/app. A new battleship in the fight. Infowars Live, available right now. We're looking for a crew to man it. You gonna sit down and play games and be a trendy? Or are you gonna be part of history? Don't sit by and let the internet and free speech be stolen from you. Take action. Mike Pence just tweeted a video that we're posting to Infowars.com right now of Hillary Clinton a few years ago saying, I don't like emails because you can't hide them from investigators. We have this criminal even openly bragging. But again, the public gets overwhelmed by that, and they won't prosecute her. So we need to just go right to the public and say, look, she's using little kids, feeding them lines about how they've been hurt by Donald Trump. It's like the Jewish family with their Jewish kid going, and he doesn't like Jews. The kid's like 4 years old. He wants to hurt Jews. I mean, it's just despicable. It's despicable using children like this. So Hillary caught using a little child. Huge controversy. This should destroy her. But we're so used to them lying to us. We're so used to the actors. We're so used to it. It's like, oh, big deal. I'm getting to that in a moment. I want the story red link. Steve did a great job covering it when nobody else was. But we need to make a huge deal. The headline isn't strong enough. It's like we need, oh by the way, we tend to not talk about our successes enough because you need to know how successful you are. I told Roger Stone last week, I said, I think we'll have five people by next Sunday. I was talking to him Sunday on air before the show. He was about to go on with David Knight. I said, I think you'll have the Clintons confronted five times in the next week. Well, it's happened in New York. It's happened in Colorado and now Ohio. Bill Clinton is a rapist. A woman holds up a T-shirt with it written on it. So I get what she's saying. Have it on a T-shirt. She couldn't get the shirt in time delivered. So she improvised, and she did it in front of Bill Clinton's face. And even though it went out on local news, it did go national. She gets $5,000. But this is a whole nother area. We got to check. Have we checked to stop rape at Infowars.com? Have any of these people contacted us yet? Because every day I ask in the morning and then no one contacts. So you'll explain during the break. Good. That's one more thing I forgot to get to. Because we're going to get these people on the show. The guy from New York, the guy from Colorado, this lady, great job. I want to get them all on the show because if it causes a cascade, my budget's only to 100,000. Other people are going to do it and it'll force it. It's not infidelity, it's rape. So we've got that clip. But before I get to this other clip, they pointed out, how are you going to pay $100,000 in prizes if you don't sell any shirts? Get the Bill Clinton rape shirt at InfoWarsStore.com. The Hillary for Prison shirt is about to be history. We have the Hillary Lock Her Up limited edition as well that shows the Gadsden snake coiled around Hillary. That's a limited edition. We have DNA Force, which is the amazing over-the-top. It's everything. It's a nootropic. It gets the dirt, you know, the garbage out of your cells with the BioPQQ, the CoQ10, all of it. It costs over $30,000 a batch just for the BioPQQ with 175 clinical studies behind that alone. Find out why it's so incredible and why it's an amazing deal regularly at $140. It's $103 right now, which, folks, there's not very much profit in this at that cost. I mean, just the BioPQQ, depending on the batch, the low end, it's $40, sometimes $55 a bottle. In the bottle has that much BioPQQ. I mean, nobody does this. This is whopper level, you know, medical grade. I mean, this is a true nutraceutical. This is what the elite take, is similar compounds, you know, similar formulas that they get from doctors. InfoWarsLife.com or call toll free 888-253-3139. And a quote, I'm not saying this is a drug. This is from Mother Nature. It's better. What I'm saying is now the big high-end clinics, they push the highest quality nutraceuticals. Well, we've just gone out and done even better, but for a third of the price or less. DNA Force, 23% off. We've got a lot of other specials running as well. We've introduced our new probiotic. We believe the very best out there. It's simply amazing. It ships to you with a cooler pack to keep it cool. But it keeps most of its quality even if it gets heated up. Try to keep it cool. Biome Defense. It is available at InfoWarsLife.com. InfoWarsLife.com. Or call toll-free 888-253-3139. Sign up for AutoShip. Get free shipping. A lot of other specials. You make it all possible. Thanks for your support. We'll be back with the video of the little girl, the actress. This is huge. In this hour, we're going to be very, very news-heavy. And I will also attempt to go to some of your phone calls. We don't have any guests today because I want to be able to cover as much information as possible. Coming up in this hour, I just started getting into this and... You know, quite frankly, if Trump goes after this and starts talking about the fact that her town halls are rigged and that most of the people are actors, they won't be able to block his transmission by that. Ignore the fact he brings it up. And then he can say, how dare them use this little girl? This is despicable. And he's going to blow up in their face spectacularly. Now, after the break, I want to play the full report of the gentleman that went into the research and analyzed this. But first, I want to just play the clip of the little girl. And I want to explain something. I'm trying to teach the rest of the media this, and I'm not bragging, but one of my biggest successes isn't just the fact that what I cover gets ignored by the establishment, but not by the rest of the media. They take what we cover, our angles, they don't give us credit, I don't care. I'm here to give fresh angles outside of the consolidated system. And one of our biggest successes is we could have broken the big, huge murder, execution, death, cannibalism videos that World Net Daily put out. But I said, Dr. Corsi has more gravitas, and this is his, what he's an expert on. He should do this. And I told the source. I didn't even call up to aggrandize myself with Corsi. I just said, I think Corsi's the right way to go with this. Though at a certain point, I kind of want to back off what I said. He is better on this subject than I, except I would have gone with the headline, shocking footage of rebels that Hillary supported, rebels that Hillary backed, caught on camera, forcing people to engage in cannibalism. Because a story like that of them with a heart or whatever goes around the world eating a heart, no one cares, I guess, that Hillary financed it and did it. But we should now that we've let them break it, we've got the footage in there, take it, put it on one of our backup YouTube channels. They don't suspend our regular ones saying we're being obscene or whatever. No, we're showing the obscenity to stop it for adult audiences and show. I mean, there's like 20 minutes of these guys being marched through. They're cutting up humans. They're making them eat the dead soldiers. And then they, you know, march them off into a pit and blow their heads off. We need to know about the liberation force that Hillary was behind and what she launched. So I did write handing it to Corsi, but it's little things like that. The trendies like cannibalism and zombies and stuff because they're so unhuman and so dead that it kind of makes them feel alive to see death. It's kind of a twist. So you can actually get trendies to tune in and go, your goddess Hillary launched people to come into a country where Christians could live in peace, where other groups of Muslims live in peace, where blacks could live in peace, and they all got murdered. Here's giant truckloads and fields full of dead black people. Why is it all black people? Because the Arabs are super racist. The Wahhabists are super racist. So here's that. That's the big angle, too. Hillary-backed extermination of blacks, black genocide in North Africa. That's true. Hillary-backed rebels engaged in mass cannibalism, made prisoners eat humans. Whereas somebody that's actually seen death, seen a little bit of killing, seen some things, you don't want to look at it because you already seen something like it. You want to see sunrises and puppy dogs and, you know, stuff like that. But see, the people that have never been in any of that, they love it. But then they might have a conscience when they see it and think, actually, this is bad, and might understand Hillary's a monster. So when we come back, Pence has come out with a powerful video we're going to play with Hillary. We're posting at InfoWars.com as we speak, saying that, you know, thank God, you know, she doesn't use emails because you can't hide it from investigators. I mean, video of her saying, I'm going to abscond, I'm a deceiver. I mean, that's the basis of getting charged, is that you say you're hiding stuff in a criminal activity. It's what makes it murder one. It's what makes it premeditated. It's what adds all the lavishment to it. This is even ABC News with a video stream a few years ago, you know, catching them in the whole deal. She hides it in plain view, teaching a criminal culture to her fellow Democrats, like Gruber on C-SPAN, teaching how to lie and deceive and being given standing ovations. Ladies and gentlemen, this is a flashback from several years ago of Hillary Clinton, a behind-the-scenes ABC News, where she's hanging out with Democrats on video, bragging about how she doesn't like to have email because investigators can then get her information. So the real headline is, this isn't just a flashback. I mean, I know it was 3 years ago, ABC News. It's Hillary caught on tape admitting she hides information from investigators. Hillary Clinton saying in 2000, this is in 2000. I know there was another one of these just a few years ago as well. I guess it was in writing. She said, don't use email, cut off the headers, that she doesn't like emails because you can't hide it from investigators. This is ABC News. Let's play the clip.
Senator Clinton and her staff now act as if she barely knew Peter Paul. But his home videos tell a different story. In fact, Paul's home videos picked up Mrs. Clinton, saying she had stopped using email messages for fear investigators would get their hands on them.
You know, that just hasn't been investigated, all that. You know, why?
Right, yeah.
But Mike, why would I ever want to do email?
No.
Can you imagine?
No.
Why would I ever want to do email?
No.
Can you imagine?
No.
Is she sitting next to Stan Lee of the comics? It is. You can't make this up. That guy always looks like he's the same age. He may live to 150. Maybe he got bitten by the radioactive spider. So on AM radio, you probably won't be able to pick it up very good, but on video, you can clearly hear it. And ABC picked up the same thing and said that. So that's a big deal right there. Okay, if you just joined us, I think this is the top story right now. Obviously, you've got Hurricane Matthew set to hit Florida and the East Coast and displace millions of people in the next few days. And we've got NBC reporters saying this is why we've got to have carbon taxes, is because we got to stop hurricanes. We've always had hurricanes. Hurricanes the last 5 years are one of the lowest cycles ever recorded. That's Weather Channel. But none of that matters because, again, if you pay them carbon taxes, they'll make everything okay. But this article is red-linked on InfoWars.com. Fake Hillary. Clinton takes question from child actor, corporate media regurgitates footage. And that's a powerful headline by Steve Watson, but not powerful enough. I mean, this is sensational. Hillary caught using child actor in stage town hall. Corporate media airs fake footage is your headline. And it is disaster. Hillary caught using child actor to attack Trump. Yeah, that's good. That's my other original headline I babbled out last hour. It's like, yeah, I guess disaster or bombshell. Hillary caught using child actor in stage town hall. and staged attack on Trump. We need to understand, it's not just like some child actor, you know, oh my gosh, another list of Hollywood folks telling us what they think. Who cares? No. It's not like that. It's staged. They pushed it as real in a fake event with an actress. We're going to go through all of this right now. In fact, let's just play the short clip, and then I've got the analysis of the entire situation. But this is such a big deal. And again, if we act like it's no big deal and just accept it, we're done. If we go, this is incredible. You've been caught again. This is the second time using actors. You claim are the public to ask you questions. You're rigging things, like you rigged his microphone, like you're rigging the election, like you stole it from Bernie Sanders. It isn't a theme, ladies and gentlemen. It's the truth. Oh, how ridiculous, the White House talking memo says, you know, the last 2 days. Media Matters, Alex Jones says that they turned his mic off. Alex Jones is a kook. Alex Jones is a... As if they dictate reality. As if, the Democrat website said you did a bad thing. You better stop talking about Bill Clinton and rape Trump. That's going to get you in trouble. No, that's going to put you in the White House. Oh, Alex Jones is talking about Haiti and the Clintons stealing all this money. When even the Washington Post admits they kept 94%. Even Chelsea, in her own emails that have come out in the State Department, that's been released to the investigation, says, Mom, this is terrible. These kids are dying by the thousands. You got to do something. She didn't do anything. I always knew you were Webster Hubbell's daughter that had some soul. So think about this. We have them. We have them. Oh, but I guess Chelsea Clinton is a Democratic Party attacker now. In fact, let's put it back on screen. They actually found the news article. You can go read the actual emails that came out in the whole State Department investigation. Chelsea saying, Mom, Dad, do something. Chelsea Clinton wrote Dad and Mom about an email about the incompetence of the Haiti relief effort.
It ain't incompetence, baby. When you get drugs that have 1/100th of what's supposed to be in them, we keep all the money and look good. And then we use the water treatment facility that's for the Haitian kids as a sewage dump. And then we keep 94.3% of the money. Oh, goodness gracious.
These are sick, 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 sick people. If my parents were like the Clintons, I would never get 1 foot away from them. And I bet Chelsea gets it and understands it. She doesn't come off as like a total demon. You live in a $10 million penthouse. You make $6 million a year off the foundation. And I noticed after she complained, she got put on the foundation and given $6 million a year.
Like, listen, I know it hurts to kill all these innocent people, but here's $6 million a year in a $10 million penthouse.
I bet you she's totally unhappy and empty and realizes she needs to expose her father. Like Darth Vader and what he did to Emperor Palpatine, you need to metaphysically, not physically, I don't wish any harm against Bill Clinton and make him a martyr, but throw your parents down a 100-mile reactor shaft. How Hillary helped ruin Haiti. Yeah, that's even the Daily Beast. I mean, I can't even believe that liberal publications. Is that the Daily Beast? I saw it there, too. Yeah. Even liberals go, these people are horrible. If you have any soul, they're the worst people I've ever seen. And the entire establishment that they represent, who are disconnected from the things they've done to the people, and create this eugenics cosmology that is for the greater good, that they hurt humanity to make us tougher. But you never go through any of this, do you? Madeleine Albright, so disconnected when Leslie Stahl goes, 500,000 Iraqi children have died of the million-plus Iraqis. And you've said toughen the sanctions to make him follow the UN rules. Is that a good price to pay? And she goes, it is a good price to pay. Just like George Soros, famous on 60 Minutes. Are you sad for helping the Nazis round up your fellow Jews? No, I'm not. It's how I survived. Won't even say you're sorry because you're messianic demon man with your little messianic demon son. And all the rave party photos of no one respects him, of him totally bombed out of his brain on Lord knows what, just all over, just mobbed, falling down, looking like a total idiot with everyone laughing at him. You're a laughingstock. You're a chicken neck, dishonorable no one. God's going to turn his face away from you at judgment Because in time and space, in a Zen concept, there is no time and space, and you are beyond the realms of death. The realms of death are only the gate. Death does not rule this universe. Beyond the realms of death, we shall all march. So let's get to it. This story needs to go mega viral. I'm skipping this network break. It's so important. It's on InfoWars.com. Twitter it. Facebook it. Get it out. Whatever you do, please. I don't want any credit. I don't care if Breitbart or anybody else. Just take our article. Put John Doe's name on it. Just get it out. Fake Hillary Clinton takes questions from child actor. Corporate media regurgitates footage. Girl who asked questions on body image. By the way, I have hundreds of articles that are all bombshell. I'm not even getting to them. This is so important. I mean, look at this. 44 Afghan troops go missing while visiting U.S. Can't make that up. Nobody cares. FCC war. Dems reject call to protect internet news, talk radio from regs, openly say they want to tax us and shut us down. Oh, that's so nice. That's so liberal. Shut down free speech. Oh, how wonderful. You know, go smack a Trump supporter in the face. Men with Mexican flags beating her in the head. But it's okay. I would be so ashamed of a bunch of white men beating up a Hispanic woman. But see, when it's a white woman, she deserves it. Because she's been dehumanized. Homeless couple having sex in public. Last straw, Denver residents. I want to just mention this because the cops won't do anything about all the homeless people who supposedly have all their rights. And it's, again, designed to break down society. We have the birth of the nation coming. Get a nice little race war going. We've got a whole bunch of news I haven't even covered yet. Sick Hillary Clinton won't attend any rallies for 2 weeks. But there will be more produced, unannounced town halls where you got 100 actors. See, people keep wondering why there's no one at her rallies, but like 20 or 30, it's because it's actors, folks. Well, she could bust in a 500 people easy. Hell, she's got over $1 billion still in her stinking war chest. But see, you've got to have it totally staged. And so many people hate Hillary. Well, somebody might get in with a Hillary Bill Clinton rape shirt that just happened again yesterday. We're going to play that coming up. But you see, oh, yeah, it's not just health, but she's pinned down. She's in the bunker. And the tanks are about 5 blocks away, Hillary, metaphysically, politically. And she's sitting there with her drawing board. And Soros says, I'll give another $200 billion to Black Lives Matter to go out and rampage. I'll give another. It isn't going to work. All the king's horses and all the king's men can't put the New World Order back together again. Doesn't mean some wonderful utopia is around the corner. It just means that people out to get us are going to be identified. Your structure is going to be dismantled. Your money is going to be taken and appropriated towards the national debt. And a lot of you are going to go to prison, not because we're even vindictive, because it's like stepping on a roach. Just got to be done, you know. You've got to be made examples of. I mean, we're not risking our lives to play games. What did Einstein said? God does not play with dice. And we're certainly not anything in the comparison to God, but the will of the people. When it's pointed at God, transcends the spirit of this world and creates a conduit like electricity through which the providence flows. And they can just now feel the dam opening and the providence coming in, collapsing on 9/11, after Benghazi, after 9/11, after all of her involvement, all of it. Biblical things are going to happen now. For the enemy, they're going to, and they're going to have superpowers. And so are those of us resisting the enemy. You're going to see the energy resonance rise and rise and rise. And just when you think it can't rise anymore, it's going to rise again. So finally, let's go to it. The town hall event took place in Hartford, Pennsylvania, Wednesday. And I saw a clip yesterday. And last night, and I went, that looks completely fake. The lighting, the people. Oh, I was like, man, that's fake. But then I moved on from it. And then sure enough, this morning I get up, it's fake. And here it is. Here's the little girl who they admit now is an actress. We've got a special report coming up on this. Here is the actress, the daughter of a Democratic Party high-level operative, anti-gun group, by the way, up there with this highly scripted event with Hitlery. Now, again, this little girl's very talented. We're not saying she's the bad person, but her parents and the people involved in this are, in my humble view, really doing some bad things, and they're trying to deceive the American people, and it's a shame. Here it is.
Hi, Madam Secretary. I'm Brennan, and I'm 15 years old. At my school, body image is a really big issue for girls my age. I see with my own eyes the damage Donald Trump does when he talks about women, they look. As the first female president, how would you undo some of that damage and help girls understand that they are so much more than just what they look like?
Oh, thank you.
Thank God the public's so dumb, huh, like Ruby said?
I am so proud of you for asking that question, and I think both Chelsea and I would like to say something about this. You're right. My opponent has just taken this concern to a new level of
difficulty. Oh, she's so obsessed. She's so genuine.
Meanness.
Oh. I came, I saw Gaddafi died, then we killed hundreds of thousands of black people all over the place, and, you know, tens of thousands more, and then they grabbed women and put burqas on their heads, and 60% of the college graduates and, like, 55% of the government officials were women, so we put burqas on them and cut their genitals off, and, you know, I'm basically married to Emma Aberdeen, and we stay in the same hotel room together, and her mother's, like, the head of the whole witch organization that oppresses women, and talk about the virtues of chopping their genitals off. On and on and on. On and on and on. You couldn't make it up. But he once, 20 years ago, had a Miss Universe pageant where she suddenly gained all this weight. She wouldn't do what she was supposed to do in your contract. You know, Mr. Universe was, when it first started, was Sean Connery. I remember seeing some documentary about him. He talked about that year he had to work for that and how much he hated it. Having to go around and, you know, work for Mr. Universe and promote their products and, you know, the supplements and stuff. Because Schwarzenegger became Mr. Universe later. He had to work for, what was the guy's, Winder or whatever. The point is that you're supposed to do it. You're supposed to, like coming up in a month whenever, or a month and 7 days or whatever, when Tim Kennedy fights in Madison Square Garden, he's got to be the weight he's supposed to be. It's some ridiculously low amount for somebody whose barrel chest is and as big as him. It's under 200 pounds. It's ridiculous. And, you know, if he doesn't, then he basically forfeits the fight or the other fighter has to agree to fight him. Now, that's a man, though. Men are and female fighters, you're going to be this weight. She knows she's supposed to be this weight. She knows it. She goes out, and Trump goes, yeah, I'm getting rid of her contract. She went and ate a little bit too much, became a little bit of a Miss Piggy. Then there's all the other press conferences, kissing her butt, how great she is, all the rest of it. I've got Rob Dew running into the control room very urgently. What do we have breaking here, dude?
Well, it has to do with this video, Alex. And there's another version of this that I saw. And
yeah, the one I saw was all HD from above.
Yeah,
and it
yeah,
showed the crowd, and it was side. All like, so they're producing totally commercials produced. Clearly with this. Yeah.
Right, right. And that was on the Last Refuge. But the actress who calls her out, I think her name's Elizabeth Shue, goes, little girl with the red bow in your hair. So they had her, it's totally staged because she's got the red bow in her hair so she could point out to the little girl in the red bow pretending like, oh, we'll just ask her a question.
And she looks, you know, she looks a lot younger. She's actually a lot older. She's an admittedly very talented actress in major movies, you name it. That's how dumb they think we are. They have a big actress with another criminal actress
right.
with Chelsea up there, and they're lying to everyone, and they admit they're so arrogant that a bunch of people have now been identified as actors and actresses.
Yeah, exactly. And Steve did a really good job identifying the other instances of that in his article, which is really well written. I saw an article about this last night, and I sent it to a couple of reporters saying we need to do a report on this. This is going to be huge. And, of course, the next morning you guys are already on it. Everybody's on it because it's – just picking out these
again, they instances. Didn't tell you it was fake. They're right. lying to you. The whole thing's scripted. This is basically fraud.
Yeah.
And we need to force this out because the mainstream media is becoming more and more not just fake or deceptive, but totally scripted.
And it's getting so bad. There was somebody pointed out something last night. I'm looking at it again. But there's an instance where NBC is interviewing Hillary after the debate. And a bunch of, it's a, this glitch happens. People think they're covering for an eye, her eyes going crazy, which could be true. They could be covering the cross eyes. But you look at it, and it's just, there's so much staged out there. Everybody thinks everything is staged, where is where it's getting to, that everything is being manipulated, everything's being staged. And but this is definitely an instance of this. And then you, the daughter's, the her dad is a state senator in Pennsylvania.
And he leads the charge to basically register and ban guns in Pennsylvania.
He's a Democrat, yeah.
I've attacked him before as one of the worst anti-gun people in the country. And I'm like, wait a minute, I've heard this name before. And it's just like, oh, my God, these people want to capture us. They yeah. think we're dumb. And you've got all these extras at the event to make sure nobody gets in and says, in fact, can we queue up first before I play the special report when we come back where this expert breaks down, you know, the actress and the other actors. And I'm going to go through some of the other admitted examples of this. Can we play the latest? Not the one in New York, not the one in Colorado, the latest in Ohio, where a woman, obviously, she can't order the shirt on time. She can't get it delivered.
Oh, right.
She wants to go out on the campaign trail where Bill Clinton's being a surrogate for Hillary, who's not going to have any public events for 2 weeks, except for stage deal with actors, except for this Sunday's event coming up.
I think that's queued up in our compilation as well.
And so if they are, if they're staging this so bad, I mean, if they're staging, of course they're staging the debate. Of course they interrupted Trump, 40-something times. They interrupted Pence 70-plus times. The rigging is out in front of everyone. I think the elite are still arrogant and don't realize how they're destroying themselves, dude.
I don't think they realize how it's going to be a landslide vote. I think if nothing goes wrong with these electronic voting machines, if that's on the up and up, which I don't believe it is, I think you're going to see.
You don't believe
it.
Homeland Security taking them all over for their safety?
That's absolutely normal. You know, that's. But there it is up on screen. You can see it now. Bill Clinton, a rapist. And I like her determination. I like her determination of just going, you know what? I'm going to write it on a shirt.
Now, I'm told we do have the video and the audio of this. The article's up on Infowars.com. Drudge Report did link to this last night. This went up after the show yesterday. This time a lady. We've had two guys do it, now a lady. I've predicted five the first week. It's happening. Great job, folks. It's not just New York or D.C. or L.A. that have national shows. Anywhere they're on the campaign trail, outside, inside, you can do it at Trump events. I mean, don't interrupt Trump, but obviously outside with the media. I don't care where it is. Get the fact out that the media is covering up Bill Clinton rape. Also, you get $5,000 if you're able to expose the fact, and I've got a limited budget, but I'm going to do this, that they're using child actors and it's all fake. I mean, we really need to get very, very aggressive here. So let's go ahead and play that clip. Here it is.
How can we have an economy that works for everybody? How can we make sure everybody gets a chance to participate? How can we help families succeed in the most important job of any society, raising children, and succeed at work? How can we live together with all of our diversity so we can all rise together? How can we be safe in a world so that we can grow? How can we do it? Don't worry about that.
We're going to be right back, folks. This went on and on, and she's right there in front of Bill Clinton with a sign saying he's a rapist. She gets $5,000. We'll be back, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Alex Jones. This is the InfoWar. All right. I get so excited that I start stepping on myself. I should set this up. I should have led the show with this today. It's just that I don't tend to focus on what we're doing up front. This is an article that ended up in the Western Journalism Center. Campus Reform picked it up. A bunch of folks are picking up what's happening. Bill Clinton rapes covered up before OU speech. A message reading Bill Clinton rapes appeared on Ohio University's free speech wall a few hours before the former president's speech on the campus, but was painted over shortly before the event because it's the free speech wall. Now, this valiant lady, they spray painted USA over it. Isn't that sweet? Oh, Hillary cares about USA, USA, as she sells it out. And so this woman holds up the shirt, not the Clinton rape shirt from InfoWarsStore.com, because there's not time to get it, not time to order it. And that's why she gets the full $5,000. I could play games and say, you know, it wasn't our shirt. No. She improvised, she adapted, she overcome. And we're going to get all these folks on the show very, very soon. So the guy in New York, it's $5,000. The fella that wasn't wearing the shirt but did get it on MSNBC, he gets $2,000. I've decided. He didn't get everything done, but still he got it done. She gets $5,000. And I got to say, the fact that Bill Clinton was there, I don't know who's more amazing. We should maybe have a vote when I have all these folks on together. Who's more amazing, the fella at the barricade and the first to do it in New York on
the morning Fox and Friends, or is it this lady in front of Bill Clinton? I mean, there's a wide shot. She's a good 30, 40 feet from him. She has Bill Clinton's a rapist. We played the other clip because it's better audio from ABC, but again, ABC zoomed it in. They wouldn't really show it. Bill Clinton, a rapist. She holds it up, probably behind the person spray painting in the legal and lawful area. They have these free speech walls where they ask the graffiti artists, you know, do it here. A lot of it's great art, by the way. I like to visit the graffiti wall here in central Austin. It's pretty amazing. And Bill Clinton goes, yeah, she does that because she doesn't want to debate me. She does that because she doesn't want to have a conversation. Oh, really? Invite her up on stage and talk about your rapes, you know, settling sexual assault cases, civilly, Juanita Broderick, all of it, buddy boy. And how you raped countries, and how Hillary covers up for you, and how you fund radical Islamists that murder and enslave and put five-year-old girls into sex slavery. You're a raper of America. You've molested this country. Now get off our back, you old crook. Crawl back into hell where you came from. So let's go ahead and play the audio of this for radio listeners.
Too many people are worried about whether there's going to be a future and their kids can have the same upward mobility they felt they had.
Well, I need help.
I know that. I know that. That's what it ought to be about. How can we have a economy that works for everybody? How can we make sure everybody gets a chance to participate? How can we help?
Okay, let's stop right there. We've shown the wide shot so folks get an establishment. Now, ABC has a close shot on her from the side. Has better audio. Let's play that clip, and I'm going to get into the other news here and also give the number out to take your calls. Here it is.
I know that.
I know
that's
that.
What it ought to be about. How can we have
that.
An economy that works for everybody?
I'm a con man.
How can we make sure everybody gets a chance to participate? How can we help families succeed in the most important
you get off
job
our
of
back.
Any society,
you don't make sure
raising
nothing.
Children and succeed at work? How can we live together with all of our diversity so we can all rise together?
What do those
How
supporters all look like? Deer in headlights. Slaves.
So that we can grow. How can we do it? Don't worry about that.
Don't worry about that.
I can tell you one thing. I love it when people come into my rallies, and it's a dead giveaway when they don't ever want to have a conversation because they know they'll lose the conversation.
By the way, I'm just told on the screen, we don't have teleprompters, but they type little messages up there in Microsoft Word to me or whatever it is. I guess we're on Linux, whatever Linux's version is. That somebody just did it again with Matt Lauer. They're grabbing the video now. So my gut told me it's going to happen five times. And I just never should question it. Like yesterday, I see the town hall and I go, that looks fake. Because I saw the HD version. It looked like a movie. And then I sat there and got a headache analyzing why I thought it was fake, then forgot to ever even cover it. Wake up this morning and it's child actors. More actors, I'm told, are being identified. The whole thing's fake with Hillary. Instead of just go with gut, go with gut, go with gut. But I have to. You know what? You can't just go with gut. But I tell you, my life just gets better and better when I do. It's amazing. And by the way, you've all got one too. And everything the globalists do is about clouding that gut. Clouding that gut. The gut is hooked into hundreds of millions of neurons with a direct connection, a wire from the brain right down to your gut. So it's not your gut. It's your brain. It's your subconscious. Hundreds of times more powerful than the conscious. And I wonder with these people that love the Clintons, I mean, how can you not know? My gut is Donald Trump. Oh, my gosh. Thank you. You're so wonderful. My gut with Hillary is, enemy, enemy, enemy. I mean, where is your gut? In fact, with Trump, my gut likes Trump so much, I'm like, is this a devilish deception? My gut's never liked someone so much. But I always second-guess my gut to my peril. You know, what is wisdom? I think it's following your gut. I mean, I tell you, some ancients worship the sun. I think we should start worshiping our gut before all the Christians go crazy. I'm a Christian. That's a figure of speech. I'm not a gut worshiper. I'm not Turkish. Though I like women with some curves and a little bit of a gut. Kind of like belly dancing. You want to get rid of fat shaming. A little bit of hips and a little bit of belly. Kind of cute, you know? All right. Lord, please control me. All right. Now, because that's all the only thing that can. Yeah, Matt Lauer, Bill Clinton is a rapist. I've been waiting for this a long time. The season. To say fire at will, Commander. And I mean politically. And the enemy looks at me and says, we can fire back. Oh, I think you already have quite a bit. We got all the messages. We went to the funerals. We're going forward. Now, let's continue. Before I get into the rest of the news and open the phones up to take your calls. Our best product that everyone should be taking every day. I ran out of water. Will somebody get me some water? Thanks. Appreciate it. I would get my own water during the breaks. I'm working in here, running around like a chicken with my head cut off. Every day when I take DNA Force, and every day I say Supermel Vitality, and every day I take the iodine, we have the proprietary special iodine. You can do it for yourself. It just makes my life better. But I've got to take it religiously. I've got to take the probiotic. I've got to take the selenium. I've got to take the biome defense. Where'd my DNA Force go? Here it is. I got to do it. And all I know is you put energy into what we're doing, you only see it get bigger. There's nowhere where you can spend your money where it has a bigger effect, viciously attacking the New World Order with everything we got. We are crazed, foaming at the mouth, totally committed, caution to the wind, on fire. And our products are a manifestation of that. I would not bring you selenium if it wasn't the very best that anybody's got out there at a price that absolutely annihilates the competition. BioTrue selenium. It's electrochemical. It's needed in the body. It's absolutely essential. They keep lowering the amount of it in the food and in the vitamins because they know, ladies and gentlemen, that it is lightning in a bottle. The hammer of Thor. And I'm telling you, the more I take biome defense, the more I take the selenium, I mean, I get high off this, and I'm not pushing this as a drug. I'm telling you personally, maybe you don't bounce off the walls like I do. This is better than Brain Force, and I love Brain Force, and it works different for everybody else. But Brain Force can make me be a real jerk. And it's like 9 at night. I've been working all day, and I've been up since 6 a.m. I take some Brain Force. Oh, my brain's working real good, but I'm a pretty mean person. But most folks didn't like that, and it's all seen as safe, all high-quality products, but that's just what happens. I can use natural stimulants God gave us, but it didn't turn out well. Not BioTrue selenium from the mighty mustard seed. And we've got 23% off DNA Force. If there's one product you get where you want to see dramatic results, I'd say it's the iodine, it's Super Male, or it's DNA Force. See, I was about to say DNA Force is the best results. I just can't say that. Because it's I mean, but people call the customer service. They go, hey, I have ruptured disc, and all of a sudden I have feeling back, and I'm tingling, and what the hell is this? This is the only product we sell that has 170 studies just on BioPQQ where we can actually say it's known to regrow nerves. So look out. Sometimes you may have an old injury, and the nerves are severed, and you take this, and a month into it, you wake up in a holy hell pain. I mean, you know, real stuff isn't a game, okay? So consult your physician. I mean, we don't sell games here. I will be damned to Hades before I screw people over. Everybody knows that. And so I'm just telling you, DNA Force is $100 with 23% off. It's a steal at $140 regularly. It is an absolute steal. Because, again, depending on which shipment we get, what the cost is in the market, $40 to $50 plus dollars for one ingredient in each bottle. That's one ingredient of a whole bunch of ingredients. Now, the BioPQQ costs more than all the other ingredients combined in the bottle. You sign up for auto ship, you get an additional 10% off, which makes it, you know, a huge discount, like $90 or $93. So auto ship's $93 instead of $103. It's discounted right now, and that funds our operation. DNA Force. If you've got the money, take it. Now, I felt guilty when we were coming out with this, and I talked to the chemists and the scientists, and I said, I really feel bad. Because, quite frankly, you know, a decade ago, I couldn't afford this. I said, quite frankly, me and the kids and everybody taking it every month, it's cost a lot of money for me. Because, I mean, I buy it from the company. It's all done, you know, above board. I go there and buy it at a discount, obviously. And they said, well, it's funny you say that. We're looking at a vision formula that has plants that we know have bio-PQQ in them, but you really aren't supposed to say that. So this is a poor man's DNA force. And I'll just tell you point blank. OccuPower is the most sickeningly powerful. It isn't just for eyes, folks, but it's stuff that's known that's good for the eyes, for the cones, the rods, the systems in the eye. Obviously, if it's good for the eyeball, it's like our prostate guard. Everything in there is good for your prostate on record. A lot of it's even got big, you know, admitted studies on it. But it doesn't matter. The point is that it's obviously good for other stuff. And so OccuPower is $29.95, and it is the poor man's DNA force. So never fear, that is available. And it's got plants. But because the Japanese, everybody have patented bio-PQQ and the rest of it, we're not going to say that here. But it's got some good stuff in it that'll give you the tingles if you got the areas that obviously have the problems. And again, I'm just a layperson. I hire the top scientists. That's what we do. And that's why we're dominating more and more at an exponential rate. Nutraceuticals, we really are having a scary effect in the market. We're making everybody basically copy us and bring in higher quality. It's like, great, you're competing now. Good. Help people. Teach us something, and then we'll copy you. That's how this works. All right, I'm done ranting. Let's go to this report since I mentioned it. We've got all these stories, all this incredible stuff happening, but the biggest issue here that I'm getting to, 44 Afghan troops go missing while visiting the U.S. Can't make that stuff up. I wonder if Jay Johnson will just give him instant citizenship by accident again. Kind of like somebody pulled a trigger accidentally, you know, in a parking lot and blew Kennedy's head off in Dallas in 1963. Kind of like cruise missiles can shoot through a window on accident. You know, no science, no planning. It's a conspiracy theory if you think there was. You're a conspiracy theorist if you don't think Guam is a floating island, because the government official said it was a floating island, and it must be a floating island, or you're a conspiracy theorist, because you're not allowed to question. You just receive knowledge from the priesthood, no matter how stupid they are, and just go along with whatever they say. General, I want to ask you a question. Why don't we just blow these Russian airplanes up? Well, there'll be a huge loss of life. Not by our cruise missiles. No, but the Russians will respond with military attack. I don't understand. How are they going to attack our cruise missile when it ain't a person? Well, that'll cause World War III. They'll hit other targets. Hold on a minute. We blow up their airplanes, then they don't do nothing. That's how it works, like Iraq, right? See, I've got hundreds of articles, hundreds in front of me, but I cannot get over this, that they think islands are floating, they think you can blow up Russian airplanes and they won't respond. But it's not that they don't think they'll respond. I could get if they were full of hubris and thought the Russians would back down. That's not going to happen. Never did. What I don't understand is that they don't understand when the generals, month after month, hearing after hearing, tell them they're going to fight back, and the damn congressmen don't know what fighting back means. This is who we've elected? I guess the elites go out and find the biggest yes men they can in the world, who are the stupidest people. You think islands float? You're our next congressman. You think you attack sovereign countries, they don't fight back? You're our next congressman. You don't know 2 + 2 = 5? You're our next congressman. You don't think it's a big deal to have a bunch of child actors at a Hillary event? Totally fake? You're our next congressman. These people are a plague. They are a disease. They are a mental illness. They're the elite? No, you're not the elite. Those of us that have it built in to work with everybody and kind of get along, and you use our tribal programming to go along with the chiefs for the better of the tribe to screw us over. You're not our chiefs. You're not our people. You're not honorable. You need to go. You need to get your hands off the nuclear weapons and go back to hell where you came from. And that goes for you, Bill Clinton. See, Bill Clinton, I'm not a big fat pig, and I know you're really skinny, I mean metaphysically, who only cares about himself. I care about my family. I care about this planet. I care about all my ancestors, and I'm not going to have you destroy the planet and ruin all of our struggles for the species. I am a human. I am the total collectivist. I am the archetypal collectivist. I am the complete collectivist. You manipulate us knowing we're collectivists to build your horrible nightmare when our true collectivism is individuals being liberty-based, acting in what's honorable, and then in the collective expressing that, and then expressing the ultimate in chivalry to take us to the next level. Something you do not understand. I could care less if you kill me. I have zero fear. I have total DNA-level fear of you succeeding and blowing the planet up. People, so here's the deal. They all want to kill themselves subconsciously. The globalists have a conscious level where they want to just take over and be horrible people, but their subconscious has enough human left in them, it's trying to kill them all the time. The problem is then it manifests in the conscious that they just want to kill all of us. They project that, and then they kill everybody. No, Clinton, the answer is give in to your subconscious. Yeah, what do you ask Willie Nelson when you're hanging out with him in his house? First, you tell him, please don't pass me that vaping bong anymore. I'm not a marijuana smoker, but when you're with Willie Nelson, you smoke it. Hardly walk out of his house the times I've been there. just being honest, folks. And, oh, my gosh, the Pharisees are getting angry about that. But I did ask you about that, about the Highwaymen song. That's the name of the song, too. I'm not star-dropping here. That's just an interesting story about what does that mean? Was that song about reincarnation? He's like, no, I actually asked the writer about that. We were singing it back in the 80s. He's like, it's more about adventure and pioneers and how these same great explorers come again and again. And that was a good point in life, wasn't it? Playing chess with Willie Nelson. Talking about the Highwaymen. You say what you want about old Willie, but he's got a soul, and Hillary doesn't have much of one. But at Willie's age, you know, he kind of gets bullied by the family and folks play along with the whole gig. But at 82 years old, who can blame him, huh? He's already done his march. We do have the MSNBC hurricane clip I was just mentioning. This is their reporter saying we need to, Ron Allen thinks climate deal is designed to stop storms like Hurricane Matthew. We probably can't play the whole clip, but let's go ahead and start playing that clip right now as we go to break.
These severe storms, beach erosion, intense weather episodes that we've had are perhaps the most practical example of what the president is talking about as the threat that the planet faces. And this is what this whole climate agreement signed by 190 nations and now ratified by about 60 or so is designed.
Is designed to do. Sorry. We're going to play the rest of it when we come back. I mean, that's like saying islands flood, folks. I mean, it's the same level of ass hattery. He knows what he just did. I mean, that guy's not stupid. Pay the carbon taxes or the hurricane's going to kill you. All right. But it's important for everybody to know that we know it's you. We know who you are, globalist. And once we know who you are, the clock's ticking. But the devil sends the beast with wrath because he knows his time is short. Let he who hath understanding reckon the number of the beast. For it is the number of a man, 666. Or the equation for global government commerce. And no amount of pomp and ceremony can even underline properly the transcendental times we live in. I'm going to go to Edward and Steve and Kevin and Ashley and Simon and many others, but I mentioned this. We didn't play the whole clip. Going out to break, I want to play the clip of the NBC reporter saying we need to get Obama's agenda through. That's the carbon tax, or more hurricanes like this will keep attacking us. Here it is.
These severe storms, beach erosion, intense weather episodes that we've had are perhaps the most practical example of what the president is talking about as the threat that the planet faces. And this is what this whole climate agreement, signed by 190 nations and now ratified by about 60 or so, is designed to stop.
So what he's saying basically is, you do the climate treaty, we don't have hurricanes anymore, even though hurricanes are at a 60-year low right now. Like, they think the viewers are so stupid that there weren't hurricanes before. Man did this, so shine on to what Obama wants. That's what Ron Allen thinks. Ron Allen. That's the name of like a paint company or something. He thinks you are a biggest chump in the world. He's just fawning desperately the system to a fading, sinking facade. We'll be back with the missing jihadis. All right, I want to go to your phone calls. I've been mentioning this for the last hour. I haven't gotten to the clip. I want to play it first for your calls. Fake Hillary. Clinton caught with a fake town hall with child actors, you name it. We're now confirming more actors there, not just this little girl. Anti-gun state senator, part of the Clinton campaign. Deceiving the public, using this little girl. It's truly despicable. Then I'm going to get into the Clintons coming out. Again, thinking you have the memory of a goldfish. How about the memory of a rock? Actually, though, a memory. I was thinking about that when I just said that. A rock has fossils. It's got ionized radiation. It's got history. A rock has an amazing memory. Let's say the lowest memory of any creature on Earth. Or a person that's unconscious, a person in La La Land, a person in Cloud Cuckoo Land, to remember that Hillary's Obamacare experiment back in 1993-94, she's already tried this. In fact, it was going to be worse than Obamacare, if you can believe that, where you just pay unlimited amounts to the corporations and they do whatever they want. I mean, it's pretty much the same thing, but it was even worse. So we have the Clintons now saying, I got to tell you, it's terrible. I don't know. I'm fighting hard against that. I'm pro-gun, too, not to tell you that. By the way, we also have video of this little girl in a TV ad for Bill Clinton going, I like Bill Clinton. He's really cool. Yeah. Remember Epstein's plane, the pedo plane, the pedo island, the little girls that Clinton flew on, all those, what was it? How many times? It's close to 100. And imagine you're like going to have your daughter in an ad with a guy that flies around with a convicted pedophile. I mean, I'm not saying anything about the family. I just, you know, they want our guns. We know that. And they got their daughter up there as an actress in a fake town hall. And then she's in ads about how great Bill Clinton is. Who settles sexual assault cases. But it's happened again. This time Matt Lauer, folks, yelling out. By the way, I only saw you put it on screen with them saying Bill Clinton's a rapist with a sign. Did they get the audio out? No audio. Okay, well, they get 1,000, even though it's supposed to be the shirt. I just can't help it. I'm going to pay out, even if I'm the judge, ladies and gentlemen.
So the video was actually captured from somebody's TV screen. So we do have audio, but it's the people in the room recording from their TV. There's no actual audio.
Oh, then the person did. Then the person gets 5,000.
Possibly, yeah. We have to see the actual clip. So we'll let you know.
Good job. And you were on air just now, right?
Correct.
Good. Sometimes they talk to me and people can't hear it, and it sounds like I'm a crazy person talking to imaginary folks, and the news makes jokes out of it or whatever, but because they think you don't know how TV works, but you do. Again, they're not targeting you. They're targeting folks that are in a slumber. The general public's not that dumb. They're in a trance, and we're here to break them out of it. So here is the report, and then your phone calls. We have fake Hillary taking questions from child actors. We have a child actor asked Hillary Clinton staged question, and then we have the actual report here. That's the one I want to get to by Spangled Media. Let's go to this excellent breakdown where he goes over every different facet of this. Here it is.
I just wanted to point out that yesterday, October 4th, during Hillary's town hall meeting in Haverford, Pennsylvania, she's resorted to using child actors to further her narrative. Let me show you. The first 18 minutes of the town hall consisted of Elizabeth Banks kissing Hillary's ass, after which she decides she's going to take questions from the audience. Here you can see the very first question asked, and this is the question that all of the media is picking up.
Hi, Madam Secretary. I'm Brennan, and I'm 15 years old. At my school, body image is a really big issue for girls my age. I see with my own eyes the damage Donald Trump does when he talks about women and how they look. As the first female president, how would you undo some of that damage and help girls understand that they are so much more than just what they look like?
I'd like to thank the Academy. I knew something was up immediately. I Googled Brennan Leach and found an IMDb page that referenced a movie called Once Upon a Time, Trillium Vein. The IMDb page credits the production company as NPB Entertainment Group. I Googled that, I found their LinkedIn page, and I also found this page, which shows the address of the production company, located a mere 31 miles away from the town hall. Once Upon a Time, Trillium Vein is even on YouTube, all 39 minutes of it. It is a strange fantasy musical that I think Tim Kaine may enjoy. And there she is, right there in the foreground. That is Brennan. So I even took it one step further, and I let some software do some photo comparison. And twinsarenot.net gave her a 76% chance of being the same person. Now, don't forget that in between the town hall and the time that this movie was produced was 2 to 4 years. So she was probably 11 or 12, and now she's 15. Now that we've gathered this information, we can go back to the town hall and show you a few technical screw-ups.
When we were in Arkansas, she fought for early education.
So Brennan first appears in the town hall video at 18 minutes and 9 seconds. But after rewatching it, I noticed that she actually shows up at 16 minutes and 11 seconds. This is probably a camera test and, you know, some sort of cue to let her know you need to be ready. Of course, if the participants were chosen at random, why is the camera ready to go 2 minutes before she asks her question? All right, she's getting ready to come up for her 2 minute warning, and you can see that she appears very nervous. All right. Two things happen here. This is where Elizabeth Banks pretends to randomly pick somebody from the audience. And I noticed that they tagged Brennan with a red bow. That way Elizabeth could uniquely identify her. And then second, Hillary quickly reminds Brennan that she needs a microphone.
How about you with a little red bow first? How you doing? Hi.
And I think there'll be a microphone coming right to you.
In addition to everything else, Brennan is the only participant that is reading something from a piece of paper.
I see with my own eyes the damage Donald Trump does when he talks about women and how they look. As the first female president, how would you understand?
And here's the top kick of them all. Hillary pretends to be surprised by her question.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Oh, this was a big coup d'etat. Oh, it's so spontaneous. Oh, wow, what a smart girl.
I'm so proud of you for asking that question.
You think we're idiots.
I think both
Chelsea
and I would like to say something about this.
How does she know Chelsea wants to say something about this? Because the question was fabricated.
Oh, they met days before.
You knew it was coming. I would just like to say, this is my own personal opinion, that Brennan Leach did an amazing job. She is an amazing actress.
But her father is a leech.
She is an amazing young woman. She did what she was supposed to. I mean, when the Secretary of State, the Democratic nominee for president, comes to you and asks you to do this very important thing, you're not going to say no. Brennan is not at fault here.
No, I agree.
But, you know, the adults in her life that told her this was okay, I don't agree with that. Also, while investigating this, I thought to myself, somebody else has noticed this. So I did a Google search for child actor Brennan. I found a thread on the Donald where a Redditor named You'll Read This actually found it himself and found a piece of information that I didn't find, and that is Brennan's father is Dalen Leach, the Democratic member of the Pennsylvania State Senate.
The super so, anti-gun.
There you go.
I want to hire Spanglevision. I don't have a big budget, but I can hire a few more reporters, just like we got Owen Schroyer. I want Spanglevision with high-tech technology, the best microphones, the best equipment as an analyst. I want him. I'm sure he probably already gets some. The problem is we try to hire these folks. They're always like, I'm actually a stockbroker making $50 million a year. You know, it's obvious because they're already smart, so they're already successful. Or I'm actually, you know, in special forces and can't do that. Or I'm actually working for NASA. You know, that's I see Smigel. That's an incredible reporter. They've usually got some gnome de plume and then, you know, pen name. And then we try to go hire them and we find out, oh, sorry, I'm the, you know, dean at a college. I don't know if people know who I am. You know, wow, your video graphics are amazing. Wow, your voiceover is wonderful. Yeah, I'm a top voiceover person. Sorry, I got to do this in secret. So Spanglevision, though, really smart, type of folks we want. Not like making stuff up, not seeing things that aren't there, but really cutting through the chase. That's who we want. That's who we need. All right, I'm going to go to break and come back and go to Ashley and Simon and Steven and Edward and Kevin and others. I've got a bunch of other clips I haven't aired yet, but I am told there was actually audio. You heard Nico, actually. Just what we have was just shot off a cell phone, but we now have found it with the audio of Matt Lauer and Bill Clinton's a rapist with a sign behind him. So that's four in 1 week. And again, I can only pay out on $25,000 prizes. 1,000 if you show the sign for more than 5 seconds of the shirt. 5,000 if you get the audio out clearly several times over 5 seconds. And you can be creative too, but I want to pay out. But if you don't follow it exactly, I'll cut it back to a couple thousand so we can go further. Because my budget's 100,000 max. Like that's a little too much for us, but I'm going to pay it out. You think it makes the Clintons mad at me? You think that they don't like it? You think I care? You want to make us your slaves. You drew first blood. You're attacking us. You're on the wrong side of history. And so if you want to bang heads, I think we already are. It looks like you're not doing too well banging heads. Now, Clinton's been on that rape plane. Pedophile guys. You know, after a while, you just, God's going to politically cut you down. We'll be back. Jeffrey Epstein had the Lolita Express, the child rape island, and the big jumbo jet flying around with him. Clinton flew on it. Some reports were over 100 times, but he's on record close to 100. And so I just want to say that we have a clip of this poor little girl that's being used in these TV ads for the Clintons, and then they think we're so dumb they have her then go ask Hillary a question like we wouldn't look it up. Again, there's this massive disconnect. And I just want to say to the family and her, please protect your child from Bill Clinton. We've launched a $100,000 initiative to expose the sex crimes of the Clintons for this. So I'm sure you're nice people, even though your father's misguided as a state senator and you're there in Pennsylvania. But we just want to protect children. So do we have that clip of her talking about how great Bill Clinton is? Here it is. Oh, we'll go ahead and play that.
The people in Congress who voted for this plan had to labor under historically difficult circumstances.
He seems like a great guy, but everything he's talking about happened in the past. Way before I was born, my dad, Dalen Leach, is running for Congress to fight for the future. He'll make sure the banks in Wall Street play fair. He'll make sure there are fewer guns on the street so our neighborhood is safe for me and my little brother.
That's enough. I can't watch it. Anti-gun ad. Okay, so that's definitely the same girl. Same name, went and asked the question. And I love how, as patriots, the Spangled Vision is still questioning whether she's an actor or whether we've got it right. No, we got it right. Now, the media, if they're forced to cover it, will just say it's not true. Or, big deal, a state senator's daughter asked a question. They're scripting all of this. They think we're idiots. This is very, very important. All right, let me tell you what else is coming up after I take some phone calls. Hillary has announced that she won't be attending any rallies for 2 weeks. Because she just has such incredible stamina. That just shows how incredibly sick she is. Clinton sought Pentagon State Department contracts for Chelsea. The new emails are showing. Just all of this is completely criminal. We have videos of people at Hillary rallies just asking questions, being beaten up. We have this report that I'm going to... You know, I'm going to hit this now, so I have plenty of time to go to you at the next segment. I'll go right to Ashley and Edward and Steve and Kevin and Simon on the other side. But
Let me just hit this because this is a short segment. 44 Afghan troops go missing while visiting U.S. ISIS-linked militants infiltrate Afghan army. And so we've got these super trendy guys. I mean, these guys are like rock stars, liberal women. I mean, hey, you put a bag over my head, you cut my genitals off. By the way, I'm not joking. Most super liberal women I know date a radical Muslim. And they treat them like crap, and they just get off on it. Because daddy kissed her butt and took her to the, you know, Disneyland and Disneyland pool parties and, you know, Disney World birthday parties. She was always mean to daddy. It's fun to have somebody. Except these guys really aren't tough. They torture women. They torture kids. They run. We'll confront them with a real adversary. But again, women were never shown a real man, so they gravitate to the cubic zirconian of men. The Islamist snot-nosed punk, limp-wristed piece of filth, spoiled, rotten brat that wants to kill innocent people. Sorry. So continuing, at least 44 Afghan troops have taken advantage of a U.S. military training program to illegally immigrate to the United States. Just since January 2015, they admit, the Pentagon admitted, the U.S. routinely brings Afghan troops to the U.S. for training, despite the fact that Afghan army has been infiltrated with Islamic militants who have carried out attacks on Westerners. But don't worry, they're going to take all your rights away to keep you safe from them. The Defense Department is assessing ways to strengthen eligibility criteria for training in ways that will reduce the likelihood of an individual Afghan willingly absconding, oh, like Hillary's been doing, running away from the law, from training in the U.S. and going AWOL, absent without leave, said Pentagon spokesman Adam Stump. Eight of the troops have disappeared in the past month alone. Oh, there's an acceleration. You know, and then the word goes out and starts stabbing, and the stabbings all start, and they scream Allah Akbar, and the news is like, we're not sure if it's Islamic connected. It's like you pop a Budweiser, drink it. I'm not sure this is connected to Anheuser-Busch. Is it connected to that? Is Alex Jones connected to stupid jokes? We know that. We know that. The doomsday plan by the globalists is to have stay-behind networks of jihadis. They can activate through their imams anytime they want and then bring in martial law and use them as a smokescreen. They are a very big threat because they're allied with the globalists. The Pentagon claimed the refugees, Afghans, are carefully vetted, like Hillary was for president, before they're brought to the U.S. But last year, FBI Director James Comey admitted the U.S. can realistically vet everyone for terror ties. And they just met a whole bunch of people last week, citizens by accident. Remember that one? We'll be back directly with your phone calls in T-minus 3 minutes. I'm Alex Jones. This is the InfoWar. They're doing everything they can to shut down the free press, spread it while it's still here. You know, we don't want to have to spy on everyone and raise taxes, but we're fighting racism. Oh, we don't want to have to only give contracts to certain companies, but we're fighting sexism. Oh. New article, InfoWars.com. It's come out that Yahoo reads your emails. That's been known for 20 years. I mean, back to AOL time. They run it through NSA data servers and then sell the questionable intelligence to the 16 different intelligence agencies. And then, of course, it came out now. Oh, but it's in the New York Times yesterday. Alex, it's in the New York Times. They're reading our email. They're scanning it at Yahoo. Why didn't you cover it? Because I did years ago. Alex, they discovered the moon today. It orbits the planet. Look, you're covering it up. Alex, the Federal Reserve is private. Why aren't you covering it? Alex, ISIS has been connected to Hillary. I please expose it. But now, this is new. This is Kit Daniels, InfoWars.com. Facebook to decrypt secure messages over cyberbullying accusations. There might be encrypted messages you're sending privately. They have to read them because of bullying. And bullying is such a problem. Your child's being taught to not respond to bullying, to fight back or speak out or get their brother to kick their ass or whatever. To just roll over and grovel. And they let bullying go on worse than they ever have, though. So you just get into this victimology. But don't worry.
We're going to censor the internet as well over bullying. And I've already seen examples of this where I've made fun of public figures and had YouTube channels, you name it, stuff suspended. And they'll say, you bullied this reporter. You called her an idiot and a moron. Well, I mean, she's a public figure. You know, we've actually had YouTube the messages. We've done newscasts on it. You know, we're suspending you over the bullying. And it's a public figure. I'm suing you. Oh, we're not suspending you over the bullying because they know I've filed suit before. I'm not litigious, but I'm ready to sue. Let's go. Because it's a war. Facebook to unencrypt secure messages over cyberbullying allegations. It's like a guy walks in, you're on top of his wife in bed, and you're like, What are you doing? I had to make sure that she wasn't anti-heterosexual. Oh, that's fine. Then I totally understand. Sure, we mind getting out there. I'm finishing from here. You walk into somebody's robbing your safe or whatever, your jewels. You're like, what are you doing? I'm making sure you're not racist. Well, of course, then it's fine. When you report a secret conversation, recent messages from the conversation will be decrypted and sent securely from your device to our help team for review. Oh, it'll be sent for review by the help team. And, of course, YouTube calls it the Hero Brigade. They admit SJW, social justice warriors that decide. And that's the community standards. There's a community of people they hire. And then they advertise to their community of people that live in, 200-foot coffin apartments and have no future but believe in the system will deliver them a future if they just grovel to it properly, as they actually put their own necks in a noose. They then go and then report. They go, since we set up an anti-free speech brigade, then when our own people go report on something and flag it, then we take it down. That's the new judge, jury, and executioner around here. Let me continue. Community standards violations can include bullying or harassment, which they define in Facebook as disagreeing with someone, close quote, and sexual or violent or exploitation. Joe Biggs had his satire piece a few weeks ago that Facebook banned and kicked off and then suspended him for a few days because he did a joke of what's really in Hillary's earpiece. It's very funny, better than Saturday Night Live. And their answer was, you're exploiting Hillary Clinton and you're deceiving an audience. This is really in an earpiece. But I think from their perspective, preying on people that think that islands float or that you can attack a Russia and they won't respond back. Like, why don't we just nuke Russia? I don't understand. Well, sir, they'll fire back. Well, it ain't no big deal. Hell, I mean, look how we did them Iraqers. I mean, I'm not joking at the level we've gotten to. These people are crazy. So there you go. Facebook also claimed a secret conversation in Messenger is encrypted end-to-end, which means that messages are intended for you and the other person, anyone else. So I love that's oxymoronic. In the same little announcement, we're going to decrypt that and see what you said, but it's only for you and it's totally private. So the island will tip over if our troops are there. Or we do need a carbon tax because the hurricane. See, we're now entering into lunacy. Total lunacy. Weirdos that just watch TV all day and walk around with their car and their outfit acting cool. Hey, I'm cool. Hey, I'm intellectual. Hey, hey, don't be racist. Hey, These people cannot find their boo-boo butts with both of their ambidextrous decimated digits. In other words, Facebook's new encryption software announced Wednesday isn't really encryption at all when the social media giant and presumably intelligence agencies can decrypt messages at will despite not being intended recipients. Yeah, what you're doing is opting in. Oh, it's for your safety, totally secure. We watch it. We watch everything. Just sign here. Oh, thank you, liberal. The false security is also dangerous given how social justice warriors are out destroying the lives and careers of individuals who make insulting comments while they beat everybody up. But that's okay. Online, because of them, free speech ends where their feelings begin. SJWs are also developing an app called Social Autopsy, which encourages users to submit the real identities of people who cause offense online, including those including employment and school records.
which, just like they always publish for decades, the list of concealed carry owners and shame them. Here's the list, the mayor says. I suggest you do something. Mayor, do you have security guards? Well, of course I do. Well, why can't I? Isn't Guam floating? I mean, we can't just blow up Russia and they won't do something back? Sir, they'll attack back. What does attack back mean? Oh, I forgot. You don't know what islands are. They're the tips of mountains above the ocean. Again, it's really starting to dawn on me. I always thought I was stupid. Is this actually a planet? Like, if aliens came here, would they say this is like a planet of retards? They'll go, oh, my God, you said retard. It's mentally handicapped or mentally disabled. Oh, you didn't respond. I'm not using your words on purpose, scum. I'm not bossed around by you in your little fantasy toilet. I don't live in a mental junk heap like you do. And I don't say that to feel superior to you. I feel low and pathetic because my species is associated with creatures like you. But the dumbasses aren't my biggest problem. It's the people that think making them dumber and herding them around is some type of art project. Yeah, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Stop now. Excuse me. Let's go ahead and the music they play with Hitler dogs on. Can we see Hitler dog for a minute? This guy was kicked off YouTube for Hitler dog, saying he was a Nazi when he's admitted. He said he wasn't on air. We checked him. A communist, liberal, super anti-Nazi, which is fine. But the point is, Hitler dog was funny. He was banned. And people supported him being banned for Hitler dog. For radio listeners, it's not as funny. But can I just have Hitler dog just to, you know, I need a hit. I need a Hitler dog. I need a Hitler dog now. While we're queuing up Hitler dog, well, that was when I made the Hitler dog joke before about my French bulldog captain, who's about twice as fat now. That was about 5 years ago. This is the rock star Hitler dog. Okay, this dog is very, very evil. Okay, this is a very, very evil creature. But before we go to Hitler dog, I actually want to play the audio in a moment. Let's go to these callers. They've held long enough, like Simon and Ashley and Edward. Everyone's talking about Mike Pence. Ashley wants to talk about the hurricane. Simon wants to talk about hurricane as well. Let's just start at the top. Let's go to Ashley in South Carolina. Thank you for being a trooper the last 30 minutes. Holden, go ahead.
Hi, Alex. I just had an idea for a T-shirt or a meme that you could use after your Hillary for prison T-shirt
Hitler dog?
Is gone. No, not Hitler dog. It's actually the skull image of Hurricane Matthew over Haiti. I was thinking we could replace the skull image of Hillary's face because there's such a likeness to the two.
No, I agree. It says something like Hillary Clinton. She's a natural disaster?
Yeah, yeah. Or who caused more destruction, Hillary or Matthew, you know?
And they're saying right now, even Daily Beast says Hillary hurt. And Bill hurt Haiti more than anything ever. I mean, they're worse than the earthquake itself.
Yeah. Yeah.
That's a great point. What else is on your mind? What do you think about Hillary using child actors?
Well, Alex, I'm actually a mother of two daughters, 8 and 9, and I
would you let them get near Tim Kaine or Bill Clinton?
Some people, no. Not at all.
We know Clinton was on the Lolita Express. I wonder if anybody else should be investigated for that. Certain party we've seen on the news the last few days. Go ahead. Anything else, ma'am?
Yeah, well, I just wanted to ask for everyone's prayers. I'm actually in South Carolina with my family, so we'll be hiding out in our adobe shelter from Hurricane Matthew.
Well, that's right. If you go to drudgereport.com, it's got some of the best coverage. It says cone hurricane swirls. It's a level four. Video update details Bahamas now. It's close. Residents not taking it seriously could leave 7 million in the dark. Areas uninhabitable for weeks or months. Satellite radar. How will this affect the election? That's what I'm wondering. How will this affect the radar? What do you think?
Well, Alex, I guess it just depends on Trump. I mean, he needs to show up.
Obviously, I'm sure he will. He may show up in Haiti, too. At least he's have the Haiti delegation there to talk about what they did. Let me ask you this. How will this affect the election outside of Trump? I mean, you think Hillary's arrogant enough She says no public appearances for 2 weeks. She just counts on voting machines, electronic voting machines. Why do you think Hillary isn't going to show up?
Well, she's got more important things to do while she hides out.
I agree. Let me ask you this. What would happen if Trump used child actors to badmouth Hillary in fake town halls? Think folks would care?
Oh, yeah. It would be the biggest talk on the media.
I might troll the media and do a special report today titled, Donald Trump caught using child actors. And I go, no, actually he didn't. It was Hillary. But now I've caught you in the moment where you're angry at Trump for being so disingenuous and fake and deceiving people. Well, see, Hillary did it. So is that okay now? Because I want to understand the psychology where Democrats tell us, well, I don't know if Hillary won the debate, but since I like her, I want to say she won. That's called being delusional, don't you think?
Oh, yeah. They're completely delusional, Alex. I can't wrap my mind around people who actually believe the nonsense.
God bless you, ma'am. Be safe. It looks like the main storm is going to hit eastern Florida and then go up the East Coast, probably losing some steam by the time it hits Florida. But they're talking about some of the waves coming in to northern Florida, into Georgia, into South Carolina, being 11 feet tall. Myrtle Beach, 6 feet. Melbourne, 6 feet. Miami, 3 feet. So we'll continue to watch that tonight, tomorrow, right through the weekend. I'm working 7 days a week right now in the next 32 days of election 2016. All right, thank you, ma'am. God bless you. Simon in Florida, you're on the air. You're in the target of Matthew.
Yes, I'm in Florida. Yeah, I'm concerned after the news that I'm seeing with, you know, this representative talking about Guam tipping over. And, you know, you're talking about big waves coming into Florida here. Is there a chance that Florida could just snap off?
Well, I mean, the congressman said that islands float, and Hank Johnson, I don't want to be a conspiracy theorist. Look, he's in a picture with flags behind him. So if he says that it's going to tump over, I actually need to put a news alert out. That's another way to troll them. The liberals will actually believe it. Florida may tump over. Oh, my God. I think everybody should evacuate Florida right now.
Or float into the clouds.
Well, that's if you, global warming. If it gets too hot, the water will boil, exactly, and it can float.
Yeah, that was the other thing, the climate change from this MSNBC reporter, Alan. You know, I've got to change my views. I'm going to have to start believing differently because it was on the mainstream media.
Well, yeah, did you see that? I mean, Ron Allen thinks, NBC thinks climate deal is designed to stop storms like Hurricane Matthew. He said, you know, we look at this storm, we got to stop this. I mean, this has never happened before.
Well, there's this guy on YouTube, Dutch Sense. You should check out his videos because he's explaining to you about NEXRAD radar and the possibility of weather manipulation.
Oh, it's declassified that in Saudi Arabia and Qatar, they are making the desert green with radar arrays that actually make it rain. I mean, that's all declassified 40 years ago. Absolutely. And so the deal is, it's weird how they say, oh, my God, pass carbon taxes or it'll flood, when they can actually, not with just spraying, not just with aerosols, not just with cloud seeding, but with these arrays, they can make the desert green. Absolutely. So could they in the future engage in weather terrorism?
Well, is that just in your face? Are they just a threat right there in your face for the people that are in the know, that understand the technology?
And Secretary of Defense, in a speech in 1997, it was in the Army Times, April 28th, 1997, said we have weather weapons.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. And this guy, Dutch Sense, man, it's unbelievable. He's got a video that he did on Texas from 4/27 of 2015 that talks about your Fort Worth, Dallas, Texas mile-wide man-made microwave-generated tornadoes. And he explains.
Well, you know, I want to start getting these great YouTubers and real journalists on, like the guy Spangled Vision and this guy. Absolutely. Nico, let's get them all on. I want to start getting these great reporters that are doing trailblazing work on. I mean, we always have, but I want to really center the show around the new media, because it is definitely up and running now. It's not just an embryonic phase or, you know, they're in the crib, you know, throwing their bottle down on the ground. That's kind of all blown over and, you know, bitching about who was bigger than them. I'm talking about those folks, other people. We've now moved on to the adult phase. I think we're seeing the golden age of the new media, and I think any attempt to suppress it will only give us our wings. What do you think?
Well, I think you should get this guy on. He was on Adam versus the Man explaining storms here in Florida and how they use, you know, chaff. The military does, and she's showing them on the screen live what's going on, and it's just unbelievable. And for you to have this on your show, I know it's controversial. I know it's going to cause you
problems. I made films about it. I had guests on it. For me,
I covered the Federal Reserve as private 20 years ago and 5 years ago. I covered 9/11 before it happened. So I've covered massive amounts of weather manipulation. I've made documentaries, sir. So I'm fully aware of all of it.
I understand you're aware of it, but you had guests like John Coleman on. John Coleman, he's more than happy to chat or tweet with me, but as soon as I ask about NexRad, which is owned by the Weather Channel, and possible weather manipulation, boom, crickets chirping, won't talk.
Well, I mean, listen, you know, I've had the founder of the Weather Channel on. That's because he doesn't know about all that. He doesn't own the Weather Channel for over a decade. And he gets hit up by that stuff all day. He can't prove that one way or the other, so he doesn't go there. But I hear you. I hear you. All right, Simon, good to hear from you. But I was saying I'll have those folks on, and then you were like, I know they're controversial. We need to have them on. No, I get it. Look, most people know there's weather manipulation going on. In 1967, Stanford Research Institute certified, we broke this with Ben Livingston and the father of weather weapons, that they could create hurricanes, steer them, control them, or kill them. We'll be back. Now, another shirt that was designed and licensed from Roger Stone is the Bill Clinton rape shirt. Looks like the, you know, communist-style Obama hope shirt, but says rape. Wear it. Get aggressive. Start the conversations. Get on TV with it. In fact, I'm going to say this right now. Anyone that gets on national TV with the shirt clearly for more than 5 seconds gets $1,000. That means, you know, behind cameras, you name it. Anyone that gets it on air on national TV and gets the words out, Bill Clinton is a rapist, or things along that line with a bullhorn, I could go to this right now. $5,000 until a budget of $100,000 has been spent.
Adoptable dogs. Well, every year, the Best Friends Animal Society helps cats and dogs who are stuck in animal shelters find homes.
Bill Clinton is a rapist.
But I think one of the kind of the things that we really need to be looking at in this debate is that Bill Clinton is a rapist. Infowars.com. Infowars.com. Bill Clinton's a rapist. Bill Clinton is a rapist.
All right.
Bill Clinton.
And I got this Hillary for Prison t-shirt, and I just want everyone to know about this, like, big presidential campaign that Bill Clinton is a rapist. Infowars.com.
Okay, thank you very much, Terrence.
How can we make sure everybody gets a chance to participate? How can we help families succeed in the most important job of any society, raising children and succeeding at work? How can we live together with all of our diversity so we can all arrive together? How can we be safe in the world?
We've had a $100,000 contest before. My budget's $100,000. That means if, you know, a bunch of people do this, I'll pay up to $100,000 and stop it. It's $1,000 if you just get the shirt on national TV. Visually, rape. Okay? It is $5,000 if you get the audio, legally and lawfully. They got to be outdoors, one of their little events. You got to have a bullhorn. You got to have the shirt on or have somebody with it, or maybe a big sign with it on it, and two of you hold it up, and then somebody else bullhorns. Bill Clinton is a rapist, not a philanderer. Hillary covers up the rape. Look, I'm not going to sit here and say, see, I told you so, that communist Chinese-style net censorship was coming to the web, because it's already here. It's being announced. The way you keep the internet open and free is you get involved more than ever. Go to Infowars.com/app. A new battleship in the fight. Infowars Live, available right now. We're looking for a crew to man it. You going to sit down and play games and be a trendy? Are you going to be part of history? Don't sit by and let the internet and free speech be stolen from you. Take action. I give you the horror of Hitler Dog.
My girlfriend is always ranting, raving about how cute and adorable her wee dog is. And so I thought I would turn him into the least cute thing that I could think of, which is a Nazi. Buddha, do I gas the juice?
Gas the Jews. Jews.
Sieg Heil.
Jews.
And then, of course, John Cleese did similar skits making fun of Hitler. But even if you were being pro-Hitler, you should be able to be on YouTube. Because offensive speech is the most protected.
But the so-called left, again, is going all out against this. It's just an illustration. So the return of Hitler dog. What level won't Jones stoop to? Well, he doesn't double black unemployment or kill 200,000 Christians in Syria or stay in the same bedroom at night with a woman's whose mother calls for cutting women's genitals off. And he doesn't have a trail of death behind him, and he didn't sell watered-down drugs to Haiti or steal 94% of the money. And that's why he's a horrible person. It's time to stand up against the evil of the alt-right. It's time to shut down free speech. And I've got the articles right here on Infowars.com. This story right here. FCC. FEC. Federal Election Commission war. Dems reject call to protect internet news talk radio from regs. Warn members of the commission they're moving forward with censorship. Just like we told you. How long's it been since you had a free press? Well, that's too long. You see, the so-called establishment media always had problems, but it's totally discredited itself now. And it's like, oh my God, we have no credibility. We're collapsing. Oh, it's the fault of the new media. They're taking all the viewers and stuff. People would love us again if they just weren't there. Let me explain something. You have destroyed yourselves. There's no putting, like Stone loves to say, the toothpaste back in the tube, okay? Let me explain that to you. People are so stupid. Your leaders think Guam floats. You think you're intellectuals because you're not. The Republicans are horrible in many cases as well, but the point is we're waking up. We're just a part of the new wake-up. You put whatever name on this you want. We're done. We don't care. We don't care what you say about us, what you do to us. We're done. Like water flowing downhill, you're not stopping it. It'll go over you, around you, through you. Just get with the program. Like Sylvester says, if you can't beat them, join them. Truth is, you were always just people like us. You lied to yourselves. So just come back down to earth. Come back down to reality. And you'll find you're in heaven. You were looking for it. It was right looking at you in the mirror there, sweeties. There's a lot of other stuff I want to get to that I haven't hit. I want to hit a few more of your calls. If you want to get into hysteria and mind control, as you know, I've predicted, it's not hard to do, that you've got all this hype by media because whatever reason it gets massive traffic. That creepy clowns are creeping around schools, are creeping around the woods, all over the country. Oh, my gosh, top story, millions of views on videos, creepy clowns. Now clowns are robbing places. Now people dressed like clowns are actually attacking people, brandishing knives. And what it is people pulling pranks or powerless people who now know in the archetype, for whatever ancestral reason, we don't like what that looks like. Wherever we've been, whatever humans have done, this planet, whatever, we don't like how that looks. Alrighty? Looks a little like something comes off flying saucers. I'm going to stop right there. But the point is that just like with epigenetics, you can put chickens for 10 generations that never saw a hawk in an enclosure. They have big studies and project triangles flying or rectangles. They don't care. You put an image of a hawk up, they all run screaming. It's genetic. That's a big question. Why do we hate clowns so much? Certain ones especially. But it's just an example of them creating this hysteria, which is now leading to all Clown Lives Matter movement they actually launched. I'm not joking. Back in 70 seconds, I'll tell you about that. And I'm going to go to... This has been holding the longest here. Kevin and Edward and others, stay with us. And Anthony Gucciardi's coming in. Tonight on the Nightly News, InfoWars investigates the clown phenomenon. With the Super Friends. And when Rob Dew and Leanne McAdoo combine forces, it creates an Owen Schroyer, also known as Clown Killer 2.0. That's just some made-up fun satire. Would you like to know more? Tonight, 7 o'clock Central, would you like to know more? We now take you live to Klandathu, where the Earth Fleet is about to mount a major offensive. You know, I told you the story. I got to know Denise Richards a little bit. And I got to know her like 11 years ago when she was still obviously in her heyday. And first time I met her, I said, we now take you live to Klandathu. She thought it was funny that time. Other time, she didn't think it was funny, though. You ever see Starship Troopers? Okay, let's go ahead and take a call. We have a call from Taiwan. Why don't I go to that first? Scott, I guess 16 hours away in Taiwan, off the coast there in the South China Sea. Scott, in the shadow of the
kleptocratic communist state of China. How are you doing today?
Yeah, I'm doing well. And you?
I'm doing all right, my friend. Thank you for calling today.
Good. I just wanted to talk for a minute about Hillary and the state of Libya. And it kind of struck me like if we kind of get disconnected from the whole thing and we think, oh, Libya's over there and they're eating hearts. And, yeah, that stuff happens.
Our government put people in to make a failed state of a modern country to target every Christian and murder them, but it's liberal. And they did it again in two other countries and liberal. But it's liberal, so it's okay. Sir, let me just, Scott, just say liberal.
Liberal.
Yeah, just go, oh, liberal, oh. Go ahead, sorry.
Right. And what I want to do is I kind of want to make it touch home to people and say, okay, well, what size is Libya? Maybe it's the same size as one of the states of America. So let's say Hillary sent in some cronies to execute the governor of state XYZ, and now it's a failed state in inside the U.S. United States of America. And you've got people eating hearts there that are literally living around the corner.
Well, making the Libyan army eat pieces of a dead person who they've cut down to almost nothing, like 90% of the body's gone. They're there dissecting the guy's body and making him eat it before they kill them. They want to send them to hell under Islam because they've been involved in cannibalism.
Yeah, it's disgusting. It's truly disgusting.
No, this is a beautiful religion of beautiful people. Why don't you accept it? It's so liberal. I appreciate your call, Scott, in Taiwan. Scott is not a progressive. He's not open-minded to wearing the hijab. Like the German TV says, oh, loving, liberal. Oh, let's have make-believe. We're so intellectual. Oh. Here, let's go ahead. Edward in California, you're on the air.
Hey, what's up, Alex?
I'm good, my friend. You don't want to just surrender to the New World Order? How dare you?
Oh, well, you know, I'm in California, and everyone else has already done so, so I'm kind of left out here.
But that's because they're intellectual geniuses.
Yeah, I guess they know a lot more than I do.
I've seen the Mark Dice videos. These people are eloquent orators. That's all I can say.
Well, I've been ordering a lot of the InfoWars Life products. They've been working great. I'm actually pausing between a workout right now. I'm pumped up, tripled my workout. It's going great. I also appreciate the Hillary for Prison stickers. However, I am afraid to post them where I'm living. So,
put them on your car. You put them on their cars. Oh, I don't mean seriously. They just want to put us in FEMA camps. They're taking over. Don't do anything drastic. Don't climb big outdoor advertising platforms, billboards, and spray paint Hillary for prison or Bill Clinton's a rapist when he's coming into town. Don't do any serious measures. Hold on. I'm going to come back to you, Edward. And then we shall speak to Kevin, Stephen, Cristal, Mickey and others, and then I will hand the baton to Anthony Gucciardi. Straight ahead. This is the InfoWar, the final last stand of conscious humans against whatever's running this takeover. All right, I got a lot of special reports to cut right after the show. The Nightly News is tonight, 7 o'clock Central. We're going to have live coverage this Sunday starting at 4 p.m. That is 4 hours before the debate starts at 8 o'clock Central. Then we'll cover the live debate, the second debate, and then have a few hours after that. But I always am here, 4 to 6 p.m. Then I'll go out of that studio where Anthony is right now into this studio, and I'll be here Sunday with the rest of the crew. We're going to have also crew there outside the debate covering it. I want to go to five more callers and hand the baton to Anthony Gucciardi, who's all ready to come in. But CJ just pointed out, he said, man, you skip breaks, then you don't even plug. We have all these sponsors want to get on air. You won't even do that. I have told them to make me plug. And I didn't plug last hour? No, you didn't. That's why when I do plug, these are great products you need. They really are high quality. They are the best nutraceuticals at InfoWarsLife.com. Game changers like the BioTru Selenium or our new Biome Defense. Biome Defense is amazing. The best nootropic that we could possibly come out with at a price way lower than the type of nutraceutical grade stuff you could find out there that you get from clinics and stuff like that. We have a lot of other specials, 23% off. On DNA Force, it's running through the weekend. That's our flagship product. And every order gets Hillary for Prison
2016 stickers in it and Infowars.com stickers. And I love how when Clinton showed up at the University of Ohio, there was a huge Bill Clinton's a rapist thing spray painted on a legal area where they have a commons area for spray painting. And then the lady went there with a shirt saying Bill Clinton's a rapist. And by the way, it happened again today with Matt Lauer. So I thought it'd be five big national hits in 1 week. I may be wrong. I might be like, it might catch on to be 20 by the end of the weekend. I mean, this is really freaking them out. Infowars.com. I want to salute all those folks. We are in contact with several of them. We now know who the fellow was in New York. He's being charged with disorderly conduct. The lawyer, we already have him, is pretty sure that he'll just be thrown out because it's out in the public. They're advertising, come have your speech. He doesn't try to get over the barricade until they start grabbing him. That was an accident. That was in fear. I said he just ought to go public and put pressure on it, and they should drop it, which they probably will do. I've had stuff dropped in New York before myself. And then we also file lawsuits and one in Cleveland when the police wrongfully arrested our camera person. I'm not against the police, but you do something wrong, we're going to sue you. That's a fact. And, of course, there was an out-of-court settlement on that, and they dropped that. So we're pretty confident there. But the other two folks didn't get arrested, didn't have any trouble. They're going to be coming on the show, so a lot of exciting stuff with that. But speaking of sponsorship, we really have great products like DNA Force, and we're doing a $100,000 contest. We've got all these reporters, all this crew. This isn't cheap. And forget just supporting the broadcast and getting a Molon Labe shirt or the new limited edition Lock Her Up Hillary shirt. Only 3,000 were printed, and that's it of that one. It funds the operation. Yes, that's a good side issue, a good side effect. You really need DNA Force. You really need OccuPower. You really need these products. They're amazing. They've changed my life. The good halogen, the true, pure iodine that we've got that nobody else has got. Infowarsstore.com, again, is the umbrella site. Infowarslife.com is where you find the supplements. There's also the free app, Infowars.com/app. It's been out about 3 weeks. Over 200,000 downloads on Apple and on the free platform there with Google Play. People say, what are you doing using the enemy? That's how the platform is built. But it's free, and it's there, and it's great to spread that to everybody you know. Even if you're not a big computer person, you listen on local radio, tell your grandkids or your neighbors or whatever, InfoWars free app, the Alex Jones free app, InfoWars Live. The way to find the direct links to the App Store and to the Google Store is Infowars.com/app or app. And did I mention? It's absolutely free. Free. Free as in rainwater. Of course, they're now taxing that. Free as in air. Now they're not taxing. I'm sorry. Free as in carbon-based life form. Not anymore. They're taxing it. So the heat is on, as they say. Let's go to your phone calls. Let's go ahead and talk to Edward and finish up your points. Go ahead.
Hey, so Mike Pence, I guess we can all agree that he did very well at the debate. However,
no, I'm really impressed with Pence. I'm really impressed with Pence.
Right, right. I think everyone is, but I think we should also be very concerned because he did mention that he will not hesitate to use force against Assad's troops and Russia. This goes in line with the media starting to embrace him. He did also mention a couple days ago that he sees Dick Cheney as his role model and that he'll use Cheney as,
No, definitely Trump brought in the establishment with Pence. He's not the worst of it. He's pro-gun and pro-life. But it's Trump running the show. Trump's got major criticism that he's a supposed Russian agent, and he's not moonlighting as Santa Claus and the Easter Bunny and the Tooth Fairy and Keebler Elves and unicorns and everything else that's imaginary. I mean, it's totally imaginary. Russia doesn't want to be under global control. The UK doesn't. We don't. No, I mean, nobody does. Catalonia, all these places are seceding out of this because it's dictatorial. But it is politics. And I'm trying to elect Donald Trump, not Pence. And let me tell you, I don't do lesser evils, but Hillary has a giant, there under her skirt for Russia. And so do the neocons. And the neocons, to a neocon, hate Trump. Trump kind of got a middle-of-the-road conservative Republican who does know how to, basically pull the levers of Congress. And Trump was honest about that. And he said, listen, I'm the one that's going to be running the show, not Pence. Look. Cautiously, I have a concern, but it's like weights and balances. Over here, Hillary is in hell. The weight is incredible. Trump is up in heaven. Now, does that mean that we're going to get perfect stuff out of Trump when he gets in? No, I'm going to say what I don't like. I'm going to say what I do like.
And if he ever takes a really big turn for the worse, I mean, I'm going to come out and say, wow, what do we do? And by being close to Trump and by being, you know, one of the people that helped get Trump elected, that's you, the audience, we will have real gravitas and real play and real weight and real standing is the word as stakeholders in this. Because if there's one thing, Trump is super loyal and also super vindictive. So look for people getting their asses thrown in jail, legally and lawfully. Anything else, Edward?
Yeah, I just wanted to also point out, or you've been covering this for the past couple of years, you know, the civil war in Libya. But I think it's good to go back and revisit it to let people know what happened and what happened under, you know, Hillary.
Oh, we wrote a big article about it. I mean, Hillary ran a mass murder operation and on purpose made sure the Christians got killed. Because she really gets demonic power. I mean, she gets a little pat on the head by Beelzebub, you know, floats down at night and, you know, kisses her feet or whatever whenever she does that. And she just is in love with him. So she does whatever her consort tells her to do. Appreciate your call, Edward. Oh, Hillary's has a sexual relationship with Satan. I'm serious when I say that. Let's go ahead and talk to Stephen in Arizona. You're on the air.
Hey, Alex. First-time caller, long-time listener. I just wanted to... I've been watching Trump, and every time he gets going, he goes into the small time with, the judge or that...
Or the beauty queen.
He makes himself look small then. I don't know what's going on with that stuff like that.
Well, let me tell you what's going on. He believes that that then gets him in the media on that issue and that he's feeding the media so they have to cover him. That's how he breaks through. And that's all the general public cares about. So he needs to prove to the public that, you know, he was right on that. Now, the mainstream media says that he's screwing up, not staying on target, not staying on the attack. Look, if he's given up 5 speeches a day and wants to spend some time on some side issues, that'll get picked up. It might actually do some good. When he's in a debate, he needs to ignore her and move forward with how he's going to make America free and prosperous and great again. So I agree with you at one area, not at the other. I mean, here's an example. Pence clearly got an A+, cleaned the floor with Creepy Kane. You know, Lolita Express. No, that's the other guy. Point is, Kane. And so all that's going on. When I look at whether Trump won, he would have lost if they hadn't overdone it, staging it. That made him the winner, even though he did not have a very good performance. So I didn't just get on air and say, oh, I think Trump won narrowly because I wanted to say Trump won because I want to be delusional. I'm the opposite of a delusionite. I think he narrowly won. Some people say he lost. Some say he won. But with Pence, he clearly won. Kane lost big time. So that's a cut and dry issue. The Democrats still say he won, most of them. But with the subject of Trump needs to get on message, this is what got him there. He's going off script and doing the things he's doing. So I think in the debate, he should laser beam like Pence did and just say, why are you interrupting me? Why are you interrupting me? Just make a big joke out of it, but also hit her really hard and point out when they, you know, if your mic's been faded down, I'd say, hey, by the way, the crowd can't hear me. The mic's been turned off. You know, you got to call it. You can't just let them bully you. But listen, he's the man in the arena, so it's easy to be Monday morning quarterback, isn't it?
Yeah. I just think, like you said, with Haiti, he could destroy Hillary if he would go to Haiti because they're inviting him there.
I know. Everything they plan is about a week out. I know he'll end up going to the hurricane after it hits the next 3 or 4 days, you know, on the East Coast. And he really should hop down to Haiti or have a Haiti delegation. A lot of them live here, you know, part of the year. And then have them up there talking about Haiti and launch an initiative for aid to Haiti since the Clintons stole the money. He should bare minimum do that. But, hey, the best laid plans of mice and men often go astray. We'll see what happens. Thank you, Steve. Let's go ahead and take another call. Let's talk to Crystal in Arizona. Come on down, Crystal.
Hello. How are you today?
I'm pretty good. How are you doing?
I'm doing well. I could be doing better. I call
what, you're not an intellectual giant? You don't like Hillary?
I think I would probably rather shoot myself in the foot.
But you can join the intellectual genius club and just go, liberal, get a big foppish hair like David Brock. It looks like you've got like a forehead, like a cone head. And I mean, because you're so intellectual, like, imagine if I grew my hair out all fake or wore a wig like I was Einstein and went, E equals MC squared. Oh, my lovey, I'm so smart. Whatever I do, you must listen to. Hey, do you like, not a German accent, but now he has a Scottish accent? Einstein does. Go ahead.
Then you'd be a part of the club. Don't you want that?
I don't want to be part of Kane's club, the creep club. Do you have children, Crystal?
I do.
Would you let Tim Kaine babysit your children?
Would I let who?
Would you let the vice presidential candidate of Hillary, Tim Kaine, babysit your children?
Oh, absolutely not.
Would you let Hillary Clinton babysit your children?
No.
That's all you need to know, folks. Would you?
To my son yesterday at the Trump rally, I would rather eat black.
Well, I would be more than happy to have my son stay with Mrs. Trump. And I'm more than willing to stay with Mrs. Trump as well if she needs any help, if Donald wants me to. Big sarcasm.
No, no.
I'm being bad. I'm sorry.
Anyway, so why I'm calling is yesterday, Donald Trump was wonderful enough to grace us with his presence here in small town northern Arizona, Prescott Valley. After he was done, MSNBC did a story while they were at his rally, and they called our local demographic white male only and uneducated.
Well, they always do that, where you can tell an upper crust Democrat is actually able to talk when they're not having a neurosis, you know, fit or some type of schizoidism. I'm serious. I mean, these people are very damaged goods. I mean, you look at a crowd of these Democrats now. I mean, they look like lost mental patients, like the mental patient ward. You know, the state hospital had the power go off. They just let everybody wander out. They're kind of like in their nightgowns, like, ugh, and I'm not trying to be mean, but then they always talk about how intellectual they are and how we're just these dumb white males, and white males are the dumbest things in sliced bread. You know, meanwhile, I'm sorry for, you know, the space program, but go ahead, ma'am.
You know how much they hate white males? I had a Hillary supporter push my 6-year-old son out of a female bathroom.
Well, of course. Well, why didn't you just say it was a woman? He can choose what he... How about say my son is a walrus and he chooses to come in here? He's a woman.
No, but aren't they supposed to support that? You know, men and women.
No, I hear you. I would have come right back and said, this is clearly Admiral Akbar from Return of the Jedi, not a boy. This is a female space alien.
Maybe because he wasn't wearing a dress and he's an actual, you know.
Yeah, I don't know. If he'd have been wearing a dress, but he had to have a mustache. He had to have a dress and a handlebar mustache. Then he would have been given access to the female bathroom. And then if he had a Hillary shirt on, and I'm not meaning to be gross, but usually this is what goes with it, and diarrhea running down his leg, they would have all bowed down and worshipped him, like Leslie Cochran.
Oh, my God.
No, I'm serious. They're building a statue to a guy who was always bombed out of his brain on drugs, totally psychotic and mean and horrible, and usually had crap running down his legs. That is their god here in Austin. They're like, we don't like it. We're Californians that just moved here. Get out. I'm like, you know, the county's named after my family. You get your ass out. Go ahead.
My biggest gripe about the MSNBC news story while they were at the Trump rally is the fact that they completely dismissed the fact that most of the supporters, which was more than half the town, were predominantly Hispanic and predominantly women. But you can't say that. You can't report that because, no. Those are Hillary supporters.
And by the way, I apologize for interrupting you. Start back over. Exactly. The biggest lie ever is to say the Tea Party's all racist. Then people that are patriots who don't happen to have pink skin, you know, gecko-colored skin like white people do, then, I mean, I actually like brown skin. You get down right on the end of it, you know. I guess, you know, true white envy here. But what I'm getting at is they then won't go out. But now that they have gone out, in many cases are half the crowd, the media is panicking. So, of course, they have a headline that it was all white male, dumbass demographic, because the last thing they want is us to actually come together. Go ahead.
That is what really upset me. You know, they're like, and then the woman goes on to say that, you know, that she doesn't understand why Trump would even bother with this town because our votes don't even matter.
Well, so she was letting you know that the Trump card, wink, wink, she had, pun intended, that, you know, it's superdelegates. Hillary doesn't need to visit the flood victims. Hillary doesn't going to campaign the next 2 weeks because, you know what? Homeland Security is protecting the election. Mm-hmm.
And that woman thinks she's going to be protected by a system that's rigged. She thinks getting rid of the grassroots, getting rid of checks and balances, getting rid of the separation of powers, getting rid of due process, she thinks that makes her safe. As if the thugs using her today will care about her down the road. She's just a stand-in, so when they steal the election, it looks like it's plausible. Do you understand that? So I've been asking, how do we counter that?
We understand that.
How do we counter that? Go ahead, Crystal. You have the floor. You have the floor.
My fear is that they know willingly that she is very, very ill. And they know willingly that Kane is out of his mind. So they're hoping that she kicks the bucket after she gets elected, so we get this crazed anti-Second Amendment loser to be our next Obama.
Well, let's just say it. He's known as Creepy Kane by the memes. I mean, he would be casted by Hollywood as to be the lead role of people that run an old creepy house where they kidnap kids and torture him to death. I mean, I'm not saying he does any of that. I think he's probably a wonderful person. The point is, he looks like a serial killer.
When I see him, I see a man in a nasty old van trying to hand out candy to little kids.
Well, I'm telling you, that's because...
Here you go, you want some candy? I'll put you in my van.
Well, listen, you don't carry around in you the type of stuff these people do and not look like a rubber-faced joker like Hillary does. And I mean, you just don't. These are demons. That's not a person when you look at Kane. That is a giant goblin. That is a... You know, you want to get a Pez dispenser and eat a piece of candy. He doesn't. You know, he has something else on the menu.
Well, I can honestly say at the Trump rally yesterday, the supporters and the people that were there, and even Trump himself, was very personable, very nice. Me being a woman, I should be ashamed, but I'm not. I am a very proud Trump supporter, and I am very happy that he took time out of his busy schedule to come to small town Arizona.
And he goes to states. He goes to states even where there are people where he's not going to win the state. He just wants to go see the fans. I appreciate your call. Great points. And by the way, the crew never tells me what to do, but they pop in when I'm going too far. I tell them to, and they said, you're going too far with the diarrhea down the leg. Listen, all I can do is tell the truth. I have seen what the left worships as their god. Can we Google Leslie Cochran, please? He lived two doors behind my last office. I was there 8 years. And about a year after I moved in there, he moved in, and I had to watch him next door to my office by this mini mart every 5-6 days a week. And so he's a dead guy. I feel sorry for him, but he was a horribly disgusting, evil person. Nasty, rude, and, you know, a guy in high heels in a mini skirt with crap running down his legs. I mean, I saw crap running down his legs like 200 times at least, you know, I mean, you know. I mean, I had it drip on me once. If you want to get right down to brass tacks, I'm in the mini mart, which I would hardly go in because he was in there. And he comes around a corner and he's smoking a cigarette. He doesn't care. He's a god. He's stomach. And all of a sudden, I feel like something hit my leg. It was in the summer. I was wearing shorts. I'm like, oh, it's Leslie. I was like, and I started going, what the hell's your problem? Jesus, get in the bathroom. He's like, oh, F you, Alex. And his tongue was coming out of his mouth, licking his front two teeth that hadn't fallen out yet. They were like piano keys sticking out, leaning up in the air. And I actually said, that's it. I said, you keep him out of this store, or I'm not coming. They're like, he's like, oh, you're homophobic. And I moved out of there a month later. He finally got us moving to bigger studios, and thank God we did. See, I'm having Leslie Cochran flashbacks. They're building a statue to him. So, yes, I know I went too far. You know why I go too far? Because Tim Kaine looks like a pedophile. It's the truth I'm saying. I'm not saying he's one. He looks like a creepy crook. And Leslie Cochran, oh, I guess they built the statue, excuse me, or they're building it. I was abused by him. Okay? The most empty, stupid, narcissistic, brain-damaged, dangerous, mentally ill person that I haven't told you one-tenth about. Like a zombie that lived in the neighborhood for 8 years, 7 years of it. I mean, I had to put up with him. I'm going to come back and introduce. It is true, though. I shouldn't waste. You know what? I'm glad I did it, though. Because I'm telling you, when I say their god is a guy with a beard with his teeth all fallen out, bombed out of his brain, being rude to people, stumbling around. You know what? You want me to tell you about Leslie Cochran? I'll tell you about it when we come back if you really want to. I haven't even gone there yet. Watch out. That's why none of the media has ever attacked me for this, because they know I will unload on your god. I will unload. Because I'm not unloading on him. I'm unloading on you. I know who you are. You worship him. City officials would tell, oh, yeah, this guy was quite the toy in town. I don't want to get into an Austin-centric type deal, but Patrick O'Reilly, one of the great members here at InfoWars, they took the O off when he got off the boat, his great-grandparents. We're adding it back. He's now Patrick O'Reilly. Patrick O'Reilly, one of the InfoWars crew members, he was going, yeah. I remember when I was here in college, they were all panicking like 10 years ago. He died like 5 years ago that he had a heat stroke. It was all what an angel he is and how good he is. So you have to understand, I was around this guy for like 7 years while he's being worshipped like Mother Teresa. And he was probably the most, the most horrible, disgusting person, not because he was gay or whatever he was, but because of he didn't bathe. I mean, it's like I don't hunt wild hogs because I don't want to have to, like, drag them into a tractor when ticks are all over them. They're disgusting. I mean, I almost retch when I think about him. He's, like, grosser than a rotten fish. And I'm not being mean to this horrible, ruined person. I pray for his soul. I feel sorry for him. It's that they held it up as a god. And Pat was going, yeah, it was crazy how they worshipped him. So, Pat, for listeners, the woman's six-year-old was kicked out of the women's bathroom because he was an evil white male.
Oh, yeah.
And I was explaining that I used to not just at my office, but when I was on Access TV before that, going back 20 years ago, he would show up and they'd shoot heroin up in the bathroom, men and women. There'd be like these black church ladies and stuff doing Access TV. They'd like complain. He'd go, oh, you're trans, you're phobic or whatever. And it's like, no, you're shooting up heroin with your friends and then vomiting everywhere in the women's bathroom. And, you know, little kids are coming out of the bathroom. There's a guy with a beard, looks like a cross between a pirate and roadkill. And, it was like cute, though, with the liberals. You like that, Pat?
I love it. You know, it's funny that he's still as relevant today as the day that he died, as the day that he had a heat stroke, you know?
Maybe he is the spirit of the liberal. I mean, he is their god. So since we got off on this is a case point example, I'm not kidding about Leslie.
No, not at all. So, again, I just briefly heard the end of this last segment, and then I couldn't believe that you were serious about the story, and that's when I told you that a few years ago, you know, probably 3-4 years before he died, he apparently had a heat stroke off of, like, Southwest Parkway or somewhere, South Austin, and everybody freaked out.
No, I know where. It was Mary Street. I know where.
And then literally
he wasn't a heat stroke.
And then people would look at every hospital, make sure, and send care packages to Leslie because, you know, they felt connected to him for some reason outside of a magnetic sticker on a refrigerator or something. So,
by the way, he had this huge two-story house. Some people were in there, two doors behind our office, with an entire floor of luxury clothing.
Well, he needed it. I mean,
Unfortunately, he didn't ever wear the luxury clothing.
Oh, I thought you just meant like the little tiny bikinis. And,
he only wore, most of the time, it was a green and white cheerleader outfit.
I guess some people are into that. Not me, but some people.
And guess what it was dipped in?
I don't want to guess.
The point is that I don't fascinate with this kind of stuff. They have made him a god. They're building this big statue downtown to him.
Well, for the people who have been around Austin long enough, you know, everybody's got like a candid Leslie story where they had some interaction with him, again, some point of relevance. But it's funny, you know, I never thought the guy was a god. I still don't think the guy was a god. You know, he obviously had his own demons and, you know, hopefully he's in a better place now.
Yeah, I hope Leslie's in heaven, actually. I do. I mean, I feel guilty even talking bad about him. I'm not talking bad about him. I just had this image of, believe me, a Hillary rally would embrace him in the women's bathroom, is all I'm saying.
Well, and I think there's a lot of other people that deserve statues of themselves before Leslie, but, you know, that's just me. I guess, you know, I haven't been around Austin my entire life, which is, I guess, my crux. And, you know, I'm the devil for not being here since I was, you know, a baby. And, you know, it's like, how long have you been here in Austin? Do you remember Leslie? Yeah, I remember Leslie. I remember Leslie for over 10 years, you know?
Well, that shows you're human, that you know that, you know everything. Like knowing your mama, your daddy, and your greedy grandma went beep, beep, beep down Sesame Street.
Yep.
All right, we've now delved into absolute. Folks, if you want a little bit of mindlessness, this has now been it, but I think it's actually been informative. I'm going to hand the baton to Anthony Gucciardi here and all the news he's got to cover. But I think, you know, if we're led by Hank Johnson, the congressman from Georgia that worries that Guam could capsize, and we've got other members of Congress wanting to attack Russia, and the military goes, but they'll attack back. And they go, but we'll hit them with cruise missiles. And they go, no, but they'll then attack piloted targets. They'll then attack us back. And they go, but the drones, they go, but they're going to hit other targets. They're going to start a war if we attack them. And Congress goes, but it's a robot. But they're not just going to hit robots. That's what I mean. It's like, but you're worshiping a guy that is obviously a mentally ill drug addict and a horrible person.
horribly rude, horribly mean. It wasn't like he was some mentally ill drug addict that, like, got kittens out of trees. It's just, it's got scared your kids in the bathroom and laughed about it and enjoyed it. You know, you're sitting there at the TV station, you're like fleeing women and children. Here comes Leslie. Just terrorizing everyone. It's like, oh, how beautiful, how cute. They got to make a South Park about this, I'm telling you. They got to make a South Park about this U.S. Army general. I don't usually make fun of how people look, but since I'm on a jag today, look at Army Chief of Staff Mark Milley. And man, I'm telling you, if he doesn't look like Frankenstein, I don't know who does. Doesn't he? Put the little electricity connectors on here. And he says, I can walk. And he can walk us right into World War III. What do you think he's actually thinking about those little thought bubble? He's thinking about cheeseburger. Or maybe he's thinking about Pepe the Frog. Because one man's cheeseburger could be another man's Pepe the Frog. You got to be watching on TV even to have any idea what I'm talking about here. All right, I'm going to punch out at this point. This has been a beautiful train wreck the last hour. Powerful broadcast, Tuttle today. Nightly news tonight, 7 o'clock Central Standard Time. We have Hillary caught with actor kids in fake town halls. Can you imagine, Anthony Gucciardi, if Donald Trump got caught holding a fake town hall, it'd be discredited, the fraud. Tonight, Donald Trump caught in fake town hall. It's incredible. Donald Trump caught using actors. Well, we always knew it was a fraud, but this attempt to deceive the American people has gone too far. Trump set to have a press conference tomorrow to step down. Well, we all knew he was bad, but not to the level of using a little girl. Anthony Gucciardi, what do you say to that?
I don't think he has to do all that. He just has to have nothing to do with people that post Pepe the Frog, and then he's a Nazi racist because people posted Pepe the Frog, and Hillary Clinton had to do a blog post about it. So I don't think he has to do anything. I think even anyone posting anything can just be labeled as whatever they want. It's all just made up now. It's like shake a box, and instead of dice, it's like little cubes, and it's like a ism that comes out. It's like racist.
Well, I want to be clear. You've only been in Austin about 6 years, 5-6 years. You are welcome. You had a great company. You came here, company you sold me, other companies you've been involved in, Smart Guy, Natural Society, you name it. You came, you contributed, you're a great part of Austin. But I love all the folks coming here who want to turn into California. They don't even know why they collapsed California or other areas.
Yeah, and the problem is that the idea of Austin, and it is interesting to talk about Austin, to give everyone an idea who's not from Austin, right? The concept of Austin being kind of like an organic thing that was just kind of raw and good and like somewhat real intellectualism and all that, then it's what happens is it's the fake, phony people that think they're behind academia and think they're behind the establishment.
They come and ruin it. They come because they hear something's cool. Then they show up and bitch about your Ford truck.
Exactly. So the realness of it was that people weren't complaining about that and people weren't freaking out about stupid things. And everyone was actually really nice. That's why I moved here, too, is people were so nice.
It's already changed, hasn't
it? Oh, yeah. Let me tell you, people on the East Coast from Philadelphia are generally not very nice. When I came down here, I was like, wow, everyone wants to talk about things. They're open-minded. Like, they actually want to have discussions. But then what happens is the people say, oh, I want to go there. And they come down, and just like basically refugees, they come down and they won't do anything to try and acclimate to how it is down here.
And by the way, I was corrected by a lot of Californians. They said, listen, we were more Texas than Texas. You know, I mean, literally, people like Clint Eastwood's dad, all these folks who were like real pioneers. And then everybody, every other loser that wanted to go join the promised land, all the people that thought there was a get-quick-rich scheme, they all went there. They're not Californians. They're like these vagabond idiots that just run around drooling. So I don't care whether you're from Michigan or New York or wherever you're from, fleeing globalism and socialist. Hey, you're a patriot. You're pro-gun. You're pro-free market. I don't care what color you are, what your accent's like, or where you're from. If you bleed liberty, we want you. But, man, I got to tell you, we got to start a project where we tell these. I want to go down in Bullhorn, Californians and others. Well, not Californians. Locusts. The locusts that were just in California that are now swarming here. Listen, get out of here. You're a disease of idiocy. Don't try to recreate what you did there, your coffin apartments and being scammed by the mafia. We don't want to live under this. Please leave.
You know, obviously, there's a lot of great people in California, right? The problem is that it's all these people that are chasing something. They're chasing a fake dream, and they want to assert it on everyone else. Like, if you go to Hollywood, people always have this idea, or like Paris, like, oh, I'm going to go to Hollywood and see the sign. It's so beautiful and amazing. I'm going to walk the streets and see Tom Cruise.
They go, baby, you're going to get to be a movie star, but first you got to do your first scene.
Yeah, let me
That's
tell
for
you,
50 it's guys, all right? Right, mommy's going to be proud. And you know what? I'm not going to be able to pay anything, but you want to be a movie star, don't you? And these people get such a dream in their head. All the local musicians get scammed by the record producer that got somebody's record done once. I need $50,000. I'll get you on the radio. And you tell them you're being scammed. Oh, no, my dream happened. I'm not being scammed. It's one step up from the Nigerian scam, you know, the Nigerian email scam. And it's just, there are people in Austin that I've known 20 years still being ripped off, still being conned over and over. They love it, though, just like they love being conned by Hillary Clinton.
That's the key term, still. They're still being ripped off. These people have these dreams that they want. It's actually very sad. But guess what? Yeah, the parasites, the predators come in and they suck off everything. Just like they come down here now. And yeah, it used to be the live music capital of the world or whatever. I guess it still is. But now, instead of, oh, hey, like supporting local music people, it's you're going to play for free and you're going to sign on to this record label. In the age of the internet, you don't need any of that. You could just be
If you went out and did something original and cool and did it for passion, then you'd be successful. But they're all like, I'm going to be a movie star next week.
I can't tell you
how many people I've seen when they go.
If you were desperate, like, I hope I could work as an anchor for CNN. Like, oh my God, like maybe I could work as an anchor for CNN. You're like getting billions of views on YouTube.
Oh, listen, like, I remember Fox News twice tried to offer me jobs, and Mancow's a witness. One time I had to sign a non-disclosure so I can talk about that. And I just said, you know what? I'm not doing it. I'll send one of my reporters maybe to be on your show or something. But the point is, they wanted to give me a weekend show. They wanted to look at me a show on Fox Business. Then if I played ball in 1 year, I'd be on Fox News. That was when they were getting ready to get rid of Glenn Beck. And I guess Beck knew about that, so he was freaking out. So I was going to be a guest on Fox when I was already on The View and stuff. He was, like, flipping out, refusing to go on air if I showed up. Like, I was trying to get his job or something. And what was funny is he was developed off of what I cover. I later learned that. No wonder he was so freaked out. Like, the guy he's impersonating is now showing up. And when Fox finally offered me the show, I said no. And then they offered me money. They're like, we're not going to fly you first class every Friday here. And I said, I'm not coming. I just kept seeing what I could get. I go, yeah, triple the money.
Yeah.
And they're like, well, this is just a pilot, you know, for 7 episodes. We're not sure. This is a big opportunity. And they couldn't believe it. I said, you know what? I don't want your thing. Quit calling me. So they had one of the executives, I later learned was with Beck, tell the New York Daily News that Alex Jones wants a show on Fox, but he's been passed over and we're not giving him one. They needed to tell everyone that I wanted the show on Fox and was kissing their ass.
Because how bad would it look otherwise? All these systems
that's
are
ridiculous.
Afraid of independent
You couldn't pay me to have a show on Fox. Discredit myself. All the time I'll have, like, you know, an accountant or somebody go, I saw you on Fox 3 times this week. And I'm like, ooh. And I'm like, I ought to tell Fox don't put me on there. Even they're attacking me. I don't want to be associated with them. And that stupid, did you hear about Megyn Kelly sent out a tweet to Hannity, one of the only half-decent people on Fox, and said, how dare Trump be coming on your show? He refuses to come on mine. And Hannity hits her back and goes, she's been on your show like 10 times, lady. Hillary never has. She's the one that scripted. You ought to be mad at her. I mean, it's just the hypocrisy of these people.
I love what Hannity gets away with, by the way. It's because his ratings are so good.
Well, it's only because he's got 3 more years on his contract. Well, I don't know. He's been threatened.
I'm sure.
And Hannity just said, from what I was told, he did come over and tell David Knight, and the media twisted this, and Hannity called me. No, I said, we were at the DNC. David Knight was there. Hannity came over with a message for me. And I didn't get it all, and said these things, and I got into it on air. Like, oh, I got a message from Hannity. The point, I don't care. We're bigger than Hannity, except for, like, in the demographic of, like, you know, 85 to 112. And I'm not being mean. That's just a fact. What I'm getting at here is that he came over and said, I really appreciate what you're doing, really great work, blah, 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 some other stuff that's off record. And I was just saying, hey, Hannity's got a soul. He's getting better. We appreciate his courage because I happen to know for a fact that's what he brought up was that he knows, we know, they've been threatening to fire him. And they're looking for anything they can to get him. So all I'm telling you is Fox News is in trouble. Go ahead.
Yeah, well, how dare you actually be kind to another person and try to work together in some capacity? Not that he even did, right? People attack you. Well, he said one thing that I don't agree with on this specific issue in 2013. That's the best, by the way. When people attack everyone, they say, well,
I agree with him, but in 2012, he said this thing.
I agree with him, but many years ago, there was a gun rally. He took over to destroy the Second Amendment. Of course, you don't know that I actually set up the event in the rally. The people got a permit and told me I wasn't welcome at my own rally, so I didn't give a crap for 3 hours, hardly even talk. Every time I would talk, they would then jump on me and say, shut up and leave. See, it's all, they don't know what they're talking about. It's just, you were at a gun rally, and you hate the Second Amendment, and you,
You know, it's that arena quote you always read that's so powerful. Everybody wants to sit back. And you get to go in the arena. Everyone gets to see everything about your life. You're on the air for 3 hours, 4 hours every single day. Every single day. You're live streaming constantly. You're putting videos out. You're showing people everything in your life. And you're in the arena.
And I'm exhausted, but pure, exhausted. I'm not saying I'm perfect. Pure will and adrenaline is carrying me through.
We all make mistakes, right? But then what happens is when one thing goes wrong, I mean, you do 200 hours, let's say, of radio. And they're like, okay, that's good. I like that so far. And then one thing, though, they're like, did you hear him say that? He made a mistake on this thing. Oh, my God.
He made a joke about how hot Donald Trump's wife is.
Yeah. Oh, well, no.
When you're storming buildings over the child pedophile airplanes Clinton's on, then you can bitch at me about liking a good-looking woman.
I mean, God. It's because, though, the silliest little things people like to freak out about, the big stuff doesn't matter. I mean, like,
because they feel like they can't affect it. They feel like they can't affect it.
Yeah, I mean, Hillary literally just having multiple counts of criminal activity. That's fine. It doesn't matter.
But 2 weeks, she's not going to give a speech now.
But you said something about Melania as a joke because, oh, my God, you're a male that's sexually attracted to females.
I'm attracted to powerful women.
Oh, my God.
I'm not attracted to little girls like on the Lolita Express. I'm attracted to women.
You're bad. You're a bad person for that. No, see, you make a
joke. Well, God made me that way. What am I supposed to do?
You're supposed to act. You're supposed to sit here and speak in your NPR voice.
And not be attracted to Marilyn Monroe or double cheeseburgers?
Not make any jokes.
I want the double cheeseburger of a woman.
Don't draw Pepe the Frog either. Okay, that is labeled as Nazi symbolism.
And
I
saw Hillary said so.
I know she did in a blog post. She was so inspired by Pepe the Frog. I'm sure she sat down and typed it up, by the way. I'm sure she was like, I'm so offended. I mean, people really think that she said, I'm so offended by this frog.
I'm going to skip this break, too, because I added a fourth hour. Why can't I skip a few breaks, you know?
Why not?
Hey, let me ask you this question. Kind of enjoy throwing like $4,000 down the toilet every hour. Well, it's a sacrifice for 4 more minutes to babble incoherently.
Key stuff.
How do you think this horrible hurricane, I'm really worried about folks on the East Coast, how is this going to get spun? Because you know Trump's going to show up and try to render aid. Hillary's so arrogant, she might not even get off the couch with Aberdeen. Can you imagine how gross that is? And not that I'm against lesbians, but man, that's really gross. Hillary, that rubber head. I wonder if she like has that jack-o'-lantern smile with Aberdeen in the bed. Like, yeah. Imagine that like rearing up over you because you know she wears the pants. She's like, Aberdeen, bullwhip, get in here. Aberdeen's like, oh, yes, master. Like, what weird neurotic person is Aberdeen with her weird mother with a hood over her head that's the main advocate of genital mutilation? I mean, I wonder if that's like some game they play or something.
I don't know. You know what? I realized about Florida, though. I think it's going to capsize. I think the real concern is that Florida is going to capsize.
By the way, some would say that Florida is actually a higher landmass, part of the North American system, and that's why it's only a few feet above sea level and floods a lot, but that it's actually the top of mountains. That's a conspiracy theory. Can we cue it up? I have a congressman, Hank Johnson, on C-SPAN saying he's afraid it would capsize. He said that was not a joke. He was serious. So I want to play this for new listeners and viewers. That's because actually, I'm going to cut a video today. I'm seriously concerned that Florida could completely capsize and kill. What does Florida have in it, like 25 million people?
I don't know. Probably more than that, a little bit. I don't know. I'll have to look it up. But I'm concerned, too, as a newly appointed scientist.
Well, like I'm afraid the hurricane, because of the global warming, that's what caused it.
It's going to capsize.
Oh, look at Spalding. We're just regular pals.
We're just regular pals. I mean, come on.
Well, here, let's go to the brain, Hank Johnson. Here it is.
Yeah, my fear is that the whole island will become so overly populated that it will tip over and capsize.
We don't anticipate that. The Guam population, I think, currently about 175,000. And again, with 8,000 Marines and their families, it's an addition of about 25,000 more into the population.
And capsize means like turn over like a
boat. The island will become so overly populated that it will tip over and capsize.
General, Chairman, can we shoot down? Listen,
anticipate
that. We keep hearing about war with Russia. There's not going to be war with Russia. We're going to have robot missiles. And yes, but then Russia will retaliate. But we have robot missiles. But then they're going to retaliate. It's like a Spinal Tap where they go, 11. Why not just have 10 be higher? And he goes, but it goes to 11.
Hey, look.
And you're like, boing, 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 boing. You know, and I'm not trying to just do this. That's why they talk about why they're intellectual all day, because they realize their supporters are the most anti-liberal, uneducated dumbasses this galaxy's ever seen.
Well, the way he says it, too. But here's the key thing. All right. That island only had 175,000 inhabitants. With Florida's 25 million, it's bound to capsize.
Now, we checked the numbers.
The math is in.
The boat that is Florida has 19 million. It's not 19 million. It's like 27 million. California's 36 million. I'm going from memory. I thought it was 25 million. Maybe, I think the headline is sometimes when during peak tourism, there's 25 million in Florida. But I guess residents, a lot of them live in New York. So I thought it was, some articles said they're really 25 million. But
either way, it's clearly going to capsize.
It's 19 million. Oh, my God. If there's 150,000. Is going to cost a cab size.
I mean, it's possible. And the way he says it, too, by the way.
It's not possible. If the government says 8,000 Marines could cause a cab size, what is 20 million going to do?
Exactly. The math is clear. I mean, look, there's no questioning this. It's due for a cab size.
We need to pay a carbon tax to Lord Rothschild and to...
cab size tax.
The cap size tax.
Every extra pound.
Because I have the article right here where the NBC reporter, Ron Allen, thinks climate deal is designed to stop hurricanes. Because, you know, hurricanes only started like 20 years ago with global warming. Did you know that?
I did. I just looked at the Category 5s on Wikipedia today, reading about the destruction and all that. In 1924, there was a big one. It's a new phenomenon.
Well, actually, if you Google, they're at all-time lows. But, hey, you know what? Whatever.
Yeah, there was an 11-year gap between the last one that hit Florida and one in 2016 on September 6th, the Hermine or whatever. There was that 11-year gap before it even hit Florida.
Is that a racist word you just used?
It was very racist.
I don't have anything intellectual to say. I just throw race out. It's like a...
No, I'm telling you, it's kind of like a certain radio host
we know that just goes, shaman. He goes, shaman. That's how you I'm a shaman.
Key buzzwords are the only thing that really matters.
Power rod. Or no, energy rod.
Energy rod. That's powerful.
There's certain talk show hosts we read about that tells women that they will achieve enlightenment. Okay, we got to stop. Oh, my gosh. Okay. All right, we're out of control. I'm sorry to the callers. We didn't get to all of you. We have been very bad today. We got Mickey, and we got Cindy, and we got Howard, and Ron, and Ryan. If you call back tomorrow, I promise you, you will go to the head of the line. Did you ever think, Anthony, though, that maybe we're crazy? Maybe the Congress is right. If we just blow up the Russian targets with drone missiles, there won't be any loss of life because the Russians won't be able to kill any of the pilots. That's a stroke of genius, right?
No, I mean, I think if we hit...
Because they won't respond anywhere. Yeah, you know, exactly. Yeah.
If we hit one side of the Russian continent, which is just endless amounts of miles, with a missile, theoretically, according to the congressional speaker, we could essentially... push the rest of it into the ocean.
We can shoot a missile right in the middle and then sink the country.
Exactly.
Because if you blow a hole in the bottom of a boat, it sinks.
The water will shoot up from the middle.
And the generals are like, yes, we can attack Russia, but they'll fight back. And they go, but we'll have robot missiles.
Yeah.
Well, no. This is beyond first dimension thinking because they're going to attack our other targets. About 5 seconds after the plane gets shot down, they're going to launch those big whatever 700s they are that go like Mach 6, and they're going to go shoot the aircraft carriers.
Just call the missiles racist, and they'll be forced to
fly. Well, let me tell you something. If nukes go off over, say, Austin, we're all going to die, just go out and call them racist, and they'll go away.
Say, you're racist. Get out of here. Okay?
Yeah. Just, hey, we're done with racist. We've grown past that now.
Yeah, and if Russia wants to do anything, we'll have a session, a sewing circle, we'll have a conch, and we'll pass it around, and we'll discuss how their military actions have affected our feelings, as the U.S. is just bombing, blowed up, and like completely destroyed. It's like, this is actually...
No, but that's okay, because the Army said we'll blow them up worse. So it'll be molten lava over there and just all on fire and everybody dying over here.
It's like someone has a machine gun at you, but then you have a bazooka and you're like, well, if you shoot me, I'll shoot you. And just everything blows up and everyone dies.
Well, it's like Dr. Strangelove, 1964. He goes, okay, you have a doomsday bomb. It destroys the whole world. Why didn't you tell everybody? You know, it's like we have the doomsday system. You can't do this now.
You can't do it.
But hold on. We fire cruise missiles. Nobody will get hurt, though.
Yeah. If they attack us, we'll just bomb them back.
But sir, we'll have to go to war. But we're going to fire cruise missiles. There won't be any pilots. No one gets hurt.
This is the new logic. Every show should just be like this. Just adopt the new logic.
You never go full Judge Smales, Anthony, right?
Goodness and badness.
Goodness and badness, Danny.
Judge Smales is a wise leader.
Lacey has a certain zest for life. We'll be back, ladies and gentlemen, tonight, 7 o'clock Central. Great job with the crew. Vaya con Dios.